Let's welcome Lauren Graham, everybody. A bit awkward. I went to give you a kiss there and that, and I got a big, I got a lot of hair.
Dance.
No. You did that thing, and I got a lot of hair on.
Does it smell terrific though?
Oh, it does. It smells.
Is it tasty?
It's tasty, and it smells like a sort of apple-y shampoo. Who's apple-y shampoo?
I'll never tell.
Oh, it is lovely though, and
thanks.
I like that clip from the Gilmore Girls.
Oh, thanks very much.
People talk very fast in the
very
Gilmore.
Very fast. Yeah, yeah. It's a whole world, in fact, where people talk very, very fast. What you talk the... very quite quickly.
I do talk very quickly. You know why?
Why?
I'll get cancelled any minute.
Okay.
That's why.
That's
how, get it out, get it said, get it done right now.
Yeah.
Say everything you need to say.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
I'm from the suburbs of Washington, D.C.
Oh, yes, I've heard of it.
Mm-hmm.
Our nation's capital.
That's right.
Really? Uh-huh. Are your family involved in government?
My father was a lobbyist and a lawyer, and now he's president of a company. So, yeah, we have, like, a reason, you know, to be there.
CIA, right? Yeah, my father was a kind of president guy, you know, lobby,
spy. My dad, he did work for an organization some of whose members were spies, but if you knew my father, you don't know my father, do you?
I don't, no. Right. Actually, I do. Come on out!
Turns out we're married.
Yeah.
Anyway, not to my dad, anyway, so...
You're married to your father?
No. Yeah. That's not allowed in most states. No. No, but there were spies in this the thing that he did, but my father, like, doesn't know where his keys are at any given time. Like, I grew up without... I've never had a house key.
Yes.
Because what's the point? You just lose them. And my father never locks the car because, as he says, what's the point? Someone will just, you know, punch the window in and break it. So why lock it at all?
It sure sounds like he's in government. What does your dad do now then?
He's not spying anymore. He's the president of a trade association that represents chocolate and candy.
Oh, I love chocolate. Do you like chocolate?
I love it.
Oh, what's your favorite type of chocolate?
I like C's caramels.
Oh, really?
Yeah, what's yours?
I like really, 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 really dark chocolate.
So it's like bitter? It's like gritty. It's like
I
dirt.
Like bitterness.
It's like
dirt women in a bar. And chocolate.
Nice.
I like bitterness. I like. Ah!
Yeah.
Ah, that look.
It's so good.
Oh, man,
bad.
Bastards.
Yeah.
That look.
Nice.
Yeah.
But so if your woman was a chocolate bar.
Are you Barbara Walters?
If you were a tree and a chocolate bar. So, but that must be hard, though, if your women are bitter and gritty, right?
No, because you warm them in a pan until they're melty. I have no idea what I even said, but...
You don't have to.
You know, it sounds quite sexy, though,
really
doesn't it?
Really good, yeah.
Would you like to come to my place and I'll warm you till you're melty?
I don't know. Well, is that creepy or cool? I'm not sure. Have you tried it? Will
creepy.
You try it? It's creepy, right?
It's creepy. I think it's creepy.
Because what if you did try to melt somebody in a pan? You know what I mean?
You'd go to jail.
Exactly.
Yeah. You'd be like...
Although, I do wonder what would happen... Do you know? Because all people do.
Okay, I'll go with that. Come on, then.
Well, it's awful, but the thing is that people usually just chop people up. They don't try to melt them in a pan.
Aren't serial killers funny?
They are, though, if you think about it.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I'm not saying that I would, you know, I would try and chop someone up
no,
or anything.
No, no, I wouldn't either, but
no.
I'm just saying, like, it would be something new to try to melt them in a pan. I'm sorry, because I'm not encouraging anyone to try that at
we
all.
Would... We here at CBS don't encourage serial killers. So, you know, this is a PSA. We should do a PSA
against the melting of people.
Yeah.
I know.
Oh, boy. This went very bad, didn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, do you like puppies? Do you like little friendly things?
Yes,
I'm changing the subject.
Oh, I do. I love puppies and also kittens.
Oh yeah. I think kittens and puppies are nature's children.
They warm my heart and make me smile inside.
Yeah. Do you know what I like? I like when you get a photograph of a kitten and it's kind of like soft focus, and underneath you write, I love you.
Yeah, I love that so much. Yeah. It's so cute.
Yeah, and you spell it like it's WUV.
WUV, I know. W-U-V, duh.
Yeah.
I think that's my second duh of the show.
That's all right. That's all right. We're a very Dada-ish show.
English major, Dada. I got it, but I stepped on it. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I know. You're funny. I should let the host talk, don't you think?
No. I'm here every night. You're Gilmore Girl.
That's
you
true.
Can get out here and zip along. And,
yeah.
We got to take a break.
Thank God.
Yeah, no.
We'll be right back with Lauren Graham.
Everybody, I'm here with Lauren Graham. Now, Lauren, you were talking about what? Chocolate? Meltiness? You like puppies?
Yeah.
What about the sports then? Do you enjoy the sports?
I do. I was only ever good at horseback riding. That was really my only sport.
Oh, I think we have a clip of you horseback riding.
No.
Hold on.
Yeah, where? Yeah. You're lying.
Yeah,
possibly. That's not me. Why am I with the thing?
I don't know. It's an old clip. Your hair was a different color.
Dress, by the way.
Yeah. And you were taller and your DNA was completely different.
But besides that was totally me. But I love to ride, but I'm from a family of athletes and like tennis players and stuff, and they find it hilarious. Like my Uncle Ed thinks it's really funny that I don't play tennis. And that's
really?
The whole joke. That's, yes, he goes.
He should watch this show because if he thinks that's funny, I got him.
Right.
Yeah. Hey, Lauren doesn't play tennis.
We'll be right back.
But that's literally the joke. He'll be like, hey, Lauren, wanna play tennis?
Your Uncle Ed sounds like a jerk.
No, he's funny.
Oh, is he?
No, he's really nice
all
guy.
Right.
He just finds the fact that I don't play tennis funny because they all play. And like my dad's a great golfer and tennis player and basketball. So my dad was my basketball coach when I was in junior high.
Really? And were you in the basketball team?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you must have been quite good then.
No, I'm just tall.
Right. How tall are you?
5'9".
That's not that tall these days.
Well, it doesn't make for an automatically good basketball player, I'll tell you that.
Well, neither does tall, though. I mean, really,
no.
I'm tall. I wouldn't know one end of a ball from the other. Well, maybe perhaps not as bad as that, but you know what?
Yeah. I don't know. So
you don't do any sport. What about the Pilates? Do you do that? All the girls do the.
I don't know. No, it's I like to run and I like to do stuff, like yoga. It makes me mad.
I like that. Yoga makes you mad.
Just the whole thing of it, and I know that that's exactly the reason I should do it or whatever.
Yeah.
But it just makes me angry.
Yeah.
The idea of going to the class and namaste, the whole thing. It just I'm angry.
Yeah, no,
I'm mad.
I'm actually getting a bit annoyed just hearing about
you
it.
You are.
Yeah.
Am I bugging you?
I like you. It's the whole yoga thing.
It's irritating.
Yeah,
isn't it?
I want to be on your side, so I'm hating it now as well.
Good.
Yeah.
That's good.
You know why I hate the Pilates?
Yeah.
Oh,
why do you hate it?
I don't know.
Oh.
Well, because I don't do it, and things I don't understand, I don't like.
Well, you shouldn't.
Yeah.
How dare anyone do something that you don't do or do well,
exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
And it's pulleys and things, and also it's an exercise where you're mainly lying down and, like, what is that? Don't. No.
I love you. I love you.
Look, I'm the kitten hanging on to the branch.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
Because nice.
that one's cute, too.
Did you ever hang a kitten from a branch?
No. No, I melted him in a pot.
Oh, that's just too bad.
I put him... No. Yeah. I don't know. What is wrong with me?
I don't know.
I don't know.
We have to go. We're out of time.
We do?
Yeah, you were just talking about being mean to animals.
I know.
That America loves.
I love kittens, though. I would never hang one from a tree.
Maybe the kitten would just be doing yoga and it would do it of its own accord.
Then I would hate that kitten.
Yeah. That seems fair. We've been talking for hours. We have to go. Yeah.
I'm bored.
We're
no,
Lauren Graham,
okay,
everybody.
Bye.
We'll be right back. I like her. That's honest. Lauren Graham, everybody. You look great. I love your jacket and your outfit, your ensemble. It's black, it's shiny, it's gorgeous.
Thanks.
What you got there? Why do you have cards?
I have a card from you.
Really?
Yeah, look what it says.
Oh, yeah. That's right, I wrote that.
Yeah.
Do you want to see it? I'll show them. It's all right. We can,
you
We've met before. Well, you hang on to that. You'll probably want to keep that.
Thanks, I do.
Put it in your scrapbook. Do you scrapbook?
No.
You don't?
No, I don't mean to laugh like it's a funny thing that people do, but it's kind of funny, don't you think?
No, no, scrapbook is America's great...
pastime?
Hobby.
Invention?
Yes.
Yeah. It's, we're proud.
Well,
yeah.
You know, you scrapbook, you could keep all the clippings of the Golden Girls and all that.
The Gilmore Girls, the Gilmore Girls.
Yeah, that too.
although
I just thought you really liked the Golden
Rue
Girls.
Rue McClanahan, Dear Diary.
Yeah, yeah.
I thought about B. Arthur again today.
You too? I once had a sexy dream about B. Arthur.
I thought you were going to say about me, about B. Arthur. You have sexy dreams about everyone. You just were talking about Sarah Palin.
Yeah, sexy dreams about her.
You have sexy dreams about
you.
Interesting people and me.
Yeah, yeah.
No, now you're just making it up.
I wanted you to feel included.
In that crowd? Great.
Oh, come on. What's wrong with you?
Now I don't want you to have sexy dreams about me.
But you're in a different sexy dream. They're in the kind of sexy dreams.
Oh,
And you're in the...
I don't like that.
Well, with a bit of...
Okay.
How are you? How have you been?
Fine, thanks.
I haven't seen you for a while.
I know.
Where have you been?
I don't know. I just, the TV show ended, and then I just, you know, have been doing a couple different things.
Did a movie. You did a movie, of course.
I did this movie.
Yeah. It looks great.
It's very good. Yeah, so I've just been doing other stuff. It's been really nice.
Did you take any time off, baby?
Where did you go? Well, I just went to Ireland with my dad.
Ah. Would you like an aspirin or something?
You got drunk. Speaking of old people.
You got drunk, right?
Well, you know, yes. Mm-hmm. And... Yeah, you know, they do. I mean, I'm of Irish descent, right? And mm-hmm. I don't want to malign my people any further, but boy, can they pour a glass.
Oh, sure.
It's like to the top of every time, and everyone with the Guinness at lunch, mm-hmm. you know, and then you get back on the bicycle. Is that against the law? I don't know.
No.
We went on a bike trip, by the way.
A bike trip?
That's why I got back on the bicycle after the Guinness.
Not just randomly. You took a bike trip around Ireland?
Yeah, around Ireland with my dad, because he's like Mr. Cyclist person. So really? If you want to spend time with him, you have to do like, you know, the like activities.
Really?
Yeah, and he just had a... yeah, you're suspicious. You don't believe me.
I'm trying out my suspicious air on to see how it works. Really? Cycling,
no,
you say?
No, I admit it. It's not true.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
How long has your father been cycling?
He's been cycling for a while. He didn't need to lose any weight, but he lost weight like that.
Really? I'm on it. I am on it.
Why? You're so handsome and...
I feel chubby.
You do?
But let's go back to the handsome.
No, let's stay on this. You're handsome, but why? You don't feel...
Sometimes when you feel a little...
Yeah,
you know,
totally.
I feel a little chubby right now. I feel like I have to drop a few.
How will you do it?
And lose some weight, too.
Reason. It's just like, I don't know.
We amuse each other, and that's all that matters.
Wait, but so what will you do to address your issues?
Cycle, that's what I said.
You will?
Well, maybe.
No, you won't at all.
Not?
Because it's really hard. You have to really be dedicated, and you need all the gear and the hats and the
You don't think
outfits,
I can do all
and
that?
The little shorts. Are you going to wear little shorts?
I'm wearing them now.
So.
Does your dad wear little shorts?
Yeah.
He does?
Yeah.
Well, that must be kind of weird.
No, I mean, it's like cycle gear, you know?
Right.
Whatever he's
what do
into.
You, what do you wear on the bike?
Little shorts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're back in that dream again.
Nice.
Yeah.
Except, you know what takes the sexiness out of little shorts is padding.
Hey, you know? Sail your boat, I'll sail mine.
But anyway, so we went...
I don't even know what that means, by the way. It makes no sense.
But we went on this trip, and it was really fun, and it rains a lot there. But,
Well, that's a news flash. I don't think anyone knew that.
Did that come up on the debate tonight?
It probably did. Yeah, I think I remember that in the debate, you bastard.
But so it rained a lot, and then also, you know, the TV show Golden Girls that I was on.
It was awesome.
No, that's okay. It was only on for 7 years.
I loved it.
No, you never saw it once.
I did.
You never watched it once.
It was shot right next to the Drew Carey show.
Name one other character on the TV show.
The girl who was your daughter.
What was her name?
Anyway, you used to shoot it right next to
I know, I remember that. that. That's yeah. where I first met you. Yeah. Little did we know that, you know.
I know, then.
Yeah, I know.
Because we would have probably behaved better.
I think we were okay.
Oh, yeah, it was a deal. Sorry. I...
Sexy dream. So, anyway, the TV show was there, and but people, I don't know if this is an Irish thing or whatever, they would never say, oh, I recognize you from your TV show. They'd say, you know, Pierce Brosnan had his wedding here. I was like, oh, yeah? Like, I love him. What? I don't even know. Like,
I think they think that all actors are yeah. friends with other actors. And
stuff. Then, does anybody... Sorry. Does anyone remember Mork and Mindy?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, right?
Awesome. Okay. That's
sometimes you don't know. Like, you know, on the Golden Girls, when I would say things sometimes to my TV daughter,
yeah.
I would say things like, you know, do you know, the, on the Waltons, and she'd be like, no idea. And so you never know. But anyway, so I guess Pam Dauber from Mork and Mindy was there
right.
at one of the hotels or whatever I was at, and the guy, and she was drinking Irish whiskey, and she asked the waiter, this is the story he's telling me, just in case you lost me on this great story. Did you get it? Okay. And so...
I just think you're adorable. Oh, my God.
Mercy applause.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
But so he said to me, and, you know, she asked me, I'm not even going to try to do the accent, especially in front of you. She asked me where the whiskey was from, and he said, I told her it was from Orson. As in Mork calling Orson,
oh,
come
yeah,
in,
yeah,
Orson.
Yeah, right, yeah.
And that was my reaction, and he goes, she didn't get it either.
Ah, yeah.
I was like, I don't know, it was just random.
Were you
stuff
both
like
hammered
that.
When this happened?
No.
All right.
No.
We have to go. We're completely out of time.
What are you talking about?
No, I'm just trying
you
to tell
you. You can't end on a hammered, a story about being hammered. Or saying being hammered.
Haven't you ever seen this show? We always end on that. We go right up to the hammered thing and that's it.
All right, okay.
Oh, but the movie's great, isn't it?
The movie is great.
See? Lauren Graham, everybody. We'll be right back. Please welcome my first guest tonight, a very good friend of this show, the lovely, adorable Lauren Graham, everybody. Lauren Graham.
He's
like, I'm the greatest soccer player in the world.
But by the way, who cares? Because so gorgeous.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's
you know
true.
I mean?
Yeah, yeah. But
just, it's so... just like, you have to tell him all the time.
What? Come on.
No.
Shall I take my trousers
no,
off?
No, hush. All right.
Yeah.
What you got there?
Well, so you wrote me a note and you put it in my dressing room.
Yes.
And I thought the people might like to see what it says.
All right. It says, welcome back, Lauren. This is your third time here, so you have to put out. Love, Greg.
I can explain this. It's the union. I don't want to do this. It's the union. It's union rules.
I just have a question, which is, should I want to continue to be on the show a fourth time? What do I have to do then?
Well, it depends how well you do on the third time. Yeah?
Oh, that's quite exciting. My voice went
right. I'd love to. Don't mind if I do.
Right. I can put that card in there if you want.
In here?
Yeah. No, it's all right. How are you? Are you enjoying Halloween? Are you going out?
I love Halloween so much. And I couldn't decide tonight if I was going to be sexy ghost or sexy maid or sexy dental hygienist or
you've
whatever.
You're definitely sexy something.
No, my point is that I don't like when adults dress up. It's just an excuse for girls to, you know, be tramps.
That's great. This is the greatest part of Halloween.
Right. Yeah. I don't know. I'm scarred, I think, from childhood.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? What happened? Tell the doctor. if you will, that no one is watching, which is actually true.
But wait, you're the Halloween doctor?
I'm the Halloween therapist. Tell me when you first started to think you were as a vampire.
Well, It's better with the double, you know.
Double hand. Well, double so hand might not necessarily be a villain. It might just be someone who's about to burst into song. There's no business like show. See, it could be that.
Good point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it. I noticed you're rubbing your leg. Did you? Have you got an injury?
No, I think, I don't know what it is. I'm just making sure my kneecap's still there, you know?
Have you had trouble with your knees leaving?
Disappearing?
Yeah.
No, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just touching myself. Sorry, it's so awful. It's so stupid.
Well, I think that means you've read the card then, clearly.
It just put me in the mind of love, you know.
Love, yeah. Mm. No, nothing says love like Halloween. And dressing up in a sexy costume.
I guess. Well, like, what are you... But you dress up all the time. You love that.
Corporate prostitute. Yeah. No, I do like to dress up. I like to put on ladies' clothes, but that's because I'm originally from Europe. It's kind of a genetic thing.
Yeah, you grow up with that.
Yeah, yeah. That's what we do instead of football.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. One year I was a coconut. This was sort of damaging. Mm, horny. I didn't know if you could say the word I said, so then I just said the word that I know that you can say because you said you can.
I said turn the clocks back, but I got it wrong.
You did? What do you mean?
I didn't say clocks. I forgot one of the more essential consonants in the word clock.
Can you say that
I forgot.
Word? Can you say that word though?
You can say it anytime you like, baby.
Yes, but perhaps there would be a reason to turn those things back. You know what I mean? Maybe that's how you meant it.
Turn them back. Quick, turn them back! It's too late, Captain! They're advancing! Turn them back! They're carrying the flaming torches. Dun, 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 dun. And the guy with the hand at the front. Ah! The leader of the mad army!
How do they carry the torch? They don't have any arms.
Oh, I was talking about clocks.
Yeah.
Which, of course, has hands. Yeah, like that.
I don't know what we're talking about.
No, it doesn't matter. Hey, what about your dog? You've got a dog.
I do.
Dress that up for Halloween.
No, I can't because I have a giant dog and there's a terrible, terrible... This should be a prop. We should be voting about this on Tuesday.
Right.
Because you cannot find a Halloween costume for a large dog. Oh, sure, if you have a little dog, they can be prisoners and witches and, you know, these little cute Snoopies and cats.
Right.
Nothing's more hilarious than dressing a dog up like a cat.
Yeah. You're right.
But my dog, who's like 85 pounds and a long-haired German Shepherd.
I've got one of those.
You do?
I do. His name's Gordon. What's yours called?
Hannah, but I didn't name her. She's a rescue. Somebody else named her.
Oh, right. Gordon's, that's his name.
You didn't rescue him, did you? You've had him since he was a puppy.
I rescued him from the adorable puppy store.
Yeah, but have you ever tried to dress him up for Halloween?
Are you kidding me? He's a German. He'll kill me.
Can you still say that, by the way?
Hey, listen. Given what those bastards were up to, it's still
that's
fine.
Right.
Yeah, we can still go after him a bit for it. Yeah.
Well, I care about my dog, and I tried to... dress her up one year, and there was really only one costume that fit, and it didn't even really fit her, and it was a lobster. So like she's got all these legs like coming off her back, and like the hat didn't fit, and I felt terrible. Don't you think that's awful?
No, I love the idea of a hairy lobster. I
didn't even fit. It made me so sad. So anyway, I can't dress her up.
Were the other dogs pointing and laughing?
Well, no, but I mean, I couldn't take her out. She would, she wouldn't get any candy dressed like that.
Well, dogs, you can't give your dog candy anyway. It's poisonous.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can't give you. I just remembered. You got that job. The one you were talking. Yeah, what is it again? Tell me. It's the, in Broadway, you're going on Broadway. Yes.
I'm going to be doing Guys and Dolls on Broadway.
That's fantastic.
Thank you.
Who else is going to be at that? Who are you doing it with?
Still,
do you know yet?
We don't know the whole cast.
Do you have the Scottish guy yet?
No, do you want to play him?
The Scottish guy in Guys and Dolls. Yeah, yeah. The guy goes, oh, hey, luck be a lady. Aye.
Tonight.
Luck be a lady anytime you like.
I wish you would come. Oliver Platt is in the show. He's going
He's
to be
terrific.
Wonderful. Yeah, and we don't know, so maybe there's still time. Do you want to sing right now for the people who are listening? See how you do?
Yeah. This is from a musical where, you know the part in the musical where the little waif walks on and doesn't know where the money's going to come from?
It's not Les Mis, but okay.
Yeah, no, but they're all the same.
All right. All right.
Who will buy my sausages? Can you sing?
Yeah, I mean, I auditioned and everything, and I worked really hard. Yeah, it's sort of where I started. I did a lot of musicals when I was younger, and summer stock, and you know, I learned a new musical every 2 weeks, and
that's
so
fantastic.
Yeah, I'm getting
have
back
you done
to
this
my.
Musical before, then?
I've not, no.
Right.
Yeah.
Have you done Broadway before?
No.
Oh, you get to go to all the swanky restaurants.
Oh, you do.
All the swanky.
Well, that's
restaurants.
The main reason to do
yeah.
a job, isn't it?
Free, yeah. It's the only reason to do this one. I get to go to the CBS commissary and get the minestrone soup. You know, the minestrone soup at the CBS
What's,
commissary,
yeah.
everybody talks about it being so great because they say, it's not as bad as everything else.
Oh.
And, and that's kind of like its thing.
No, I love New York. I lived there. I went to college there. I have a place there, and I'm really excited to go there.
Well, then you better get off then.
I better leave right now.
You better leave right now.
But how's our love affair going to happen?
Well, we'll take a break. We'll see how it goes.
All right.
All right.
Oh,
lovely
then.
Lauren Graham, everybody.
Halloween's Eve show, where we're getting ready for Halloween by dressing up as a guy. Dressing up as a geography teacher. All right, kids, today we're going to talk about France. It's over there. People live in it. Get out. My first guest tonight, I always like to have this guest. At Halloween. She's a very beautiful actress, a good friend of the show, the very, very lovely Lauren Graham, everybody. Lauren Graham. Lauren! Wow, you look sensational. Boots! Oh, yeah!
I'm dressing as preppy dominatrix.
Yeah, I like it. Preppy dominatrix is awesome.
Yeah, she wants you to do what she tells you, but it's okay if you don't want to. She's preppy dominatrix.
I like it. Perky sadism. By the way, perky sadism is the name I used to dance under. These are, may I?
Yeah.
Wear them?
May you.
May I touch them?
Yeah.
Go, all right,
do
then. Can
it.
I touch your boots too?
Yeah.
All right.
I didn't even feel that. Do it.
It's nice. It's lovely. It's like a sofa. It's like you're wearing a sofa on your legs. It's so great.
What could be sexier than that?
Hey, sofas are sexy. A lot of good stuff happens in sofas.
In them or on them.
In them too, yeah. Inside sofas.
There's all kinds of like springs and cotton stuff. In them, you know?
Yeah. Okay, so now you famously love Halloween more than any other holiday, don't you?
I hate Halloween so much.
I know.
And this year, it's it's especially hideous for me personally because I have to go to a party and dress up.
That's why everybody does in Halloween. Don't
Not
be such
me.
A
Not
don't be
me.
Such a Mr. Scrooge. Wear your boots. Wear your boots and nothing else.
There is a costume.
There, you're damn right. There's a costume.
What if I have to get gas or something?
Go to full service.
Good point.
You'll get full service either way. So, well, what are you going to go as then?
I don't know.
I don't know.
What are you talking about? It's hours away. You gotta know.
I know. It just reminds me when I didn't have a Halloween costume as a kid, and so I made one up. And do you want to know what it was?
No.
Okay.
Of course I do. Yes.
It was I took my dad's brown cable knit sweater, and I rode horses, and I had my brown riding hat, and I tucked myself in the sweater, and I tried to roll across the gym because I was a coconut.
That's adorable. Why don't you do that again, then?
I did the Halloween buttery. Do you ever put butter in your hair?
No. Why?
It wasn't real butter. It was margarine, you know. It was,
why? For what?
To dress up as Dracula. Gosh, don't you even watch this show? You don't even watch this show when you're
on it. Yes, I do watch this show.
Really?
I don't watch it when I'm on it. Because who could do that? Do you watch your own self? I guess you have to.
No. No, I can't.
You can't, right?
No, it's like awful. Listening to your voice on a tape or reading your own writing or looking at your own underpants. Who wants
Wait
to do
minute.
That?
But you must have to do all those things.
No. When I'm finished with a pair of underpants, I get them on a stick and I take them out the backyard and I burn them.
So angry at your underpants. They
I'm
served you so
angry
well.
At them. I'm not angry at them. It's just time for them to go.
Ew! After one use?
One use. I am a spectacularly flatulent man.
Wow. Is it just because you're sick right now?
Sure.
No, it's all the time?
No, I'm not that farty. I'm a little bit farty. No, it's farty as, you know, like Larry King, who's my god of fartiness.
Is he the fartiest person you've ever met?
No. There is a guy.
Yeah?
Who I know.
Yeah?
Who can fart when he wants.
Why is this what we're talking about?
Yeah, you started it. With your boots. I can't remember.
Wait, but... look, you wrote this book.
I did write that book. What? Look, here's a clue. There's a picture of me in the cover, and my name's written there. Is this a quiz?
No, but I wanted to talk about, because I came to your book party.
I remember. I saw you there. I was there, too.
I know, because you wrote it. Yeah. And you told me that I was not in this book.
You're not.
Craig.
Where did you find yourself in the book? Where does it say?
Craig, here's where I am. And... was and is a great talker. She's funny and interested in people. Oh.
All right.
Wait, there's two more.
I had no idea I'd written such a lame book. How fantastic.
No, because you have to change the names to protect the innocent.
All right.
Wait, I just have two more.
Oh, only two? Thank you.
No, by the way, I have like 10 more, but I cut it down.
Right.
The landlord, Tommy, was an Irish fella and a terrific storyteller. Thank you so much.
Oh, you really like this, don't you? You really think you've got something going, don't you? Oh, I've had a great idea and I'm really going to go with it. Go on then.
It just makes me laugh.
No, it does. I'm glad you're having a good time.
No, I'm not even going to read the last one.
No, come on, no. Come on, you have to read the last one. Do you want me to get that?
No, that's okay.
All right, then.
That's my very expensive bookmarks. Betty has been on TV as long as the medium has existed. Slight exaggeration. And she possesses, without doubt, the finest comedic timing of any human being I've ever seen in movies, TV, or real life. That was so nice of you.
Well, it's amazing you managed to spot yourself. I thought I hadn't.
So many times.
Yeah, well, yeah. I talk about you a lot, apparently, over the years.
I know.
Fine. Are you back in L.A. now?
Yes.
Or are you still in New York?
Are you so sick? Do you have the fever coming on right now? A little bit?
What kind of fever? Because those boots are getting me into some kind of...
Boots that are like a sofa fever.
Yeah. Boots that are like a sofa. Starring Lauren Graham.
Why is our porn music so terrible?
I know, you'd think they go to all that trouble of making everything else great. Why would they put some good music on?
Yeah, everything else is so great.
Do you know the last time I saw porn was by accident?
Yeah, well, it's by accident?
It's by accident. And I, after I paid for it and waited for it to come up on the hotel thing,
I went, wow, that's much better lit than my show.
Did you feel like people looked better and more youthful?
They did. They clearly did. And also, just the general lighting was better. And actually, so was the music. No disrespect, but it was...
Do you think that a sign of becoming older is when you're watching a porn movie that you paid for in a hotel room and you're noticing the lighting and the music?
You know what's even worse? When you go, when you watch it and you go, these people must be freezing. That's when you know.
That's when you know, for sure.
Are you a big fan of pornography? Do you watch a lot of it? You seem to know a lot about it.
I hate Halloween.
Yes. What about Christmas? Do you like Christmas?
I went back to that. I like Christmas. I'm not, you know...
Evil.
Evil. I'm not really a dominatrix. They hate Christmas.
Do they really? No, I think they like it.
Not that
it.
I would know. I'm like tearing up because
yeah,
I think you're giving
on?
Me the swine flu.
I'm not giving you the swine flu.
You are. I'm like suddenly like...
I don't think I have it. I've got swine flu.
How do you know for sure I'm the guinea pig? If I end up with it, then you know you had it. Yeah.
No, I don't think I have it, but I've got what everybody else has got, which is...
The swine flu.
Fever. Swine flu fever. I've got swine flu fever. I'm panicked about the swine flu. I don't necessarily have it. I'm just scared that I have it.
You know what you have to do? You have to rinse your nose out with salt water. Do you do that?
All the time.
Really? With the thing. You have to
Not
do the
Not just my
thing.
Nose. Everywhere I can get to.
That's so weird because you're still so farty. You'd think you'd clean it up.
I'm not really that farty. How long have you been sitting here talking to me?
Long enough to smell that you're fine.
Oh, right, exactly.
I'm just saying, if you're going to talk about pornography and farting, then, you know, it's not really your best foot forward, is it?
Hey, it's knowing your audience. They don't mind. If you don't mind me saying, maybe on the Gilmore Girls, a bit more fartiness.
And it would still be on
still
the air.
Still be on the air, that's all I'm saying.
There is a nice lady over there who's like, farting, I don't know. I feel bad. I feel it bad now.
Oh, yeah, my eye is always drawn to the person who hates me.
Me too.
Sometimes I
me
marry
too.
Them.
Me too. Oh.
Yeah.
Just did a musical on the Broadway, you know.
Oh, you're on the Broadway?
Yeah.
What, you mean in the New York City?
In the New York City, Manhattan.
And yeah. what was the musical?
Well, A, you sent me flowers on opening night, which was so sweet of you. To the degree that I figured it couldn't possibly have been you who did it, because I've just like lived in LA too long. So when I saw you recently, I said, "Do you know that you sent me flowers?" And you said, "Yes." And then
yes.
Who's the idiot? Me. But you can always.
But what was I going to say? No.
Right. Oh, you probably didn't know that you did.
I, of course, I sent you flowers, and I remember what I wrote on them. Do you?
Happy opening night.
You don't even remember.
What did you say?
Good luck on your opening night.
Which, P.S., is bad luck in the theater. Everybody knows that.
That's why I said bad luck. I was testing you.
Oh.
I can't remember what I wrote, but it was something supportive.
You wrote something
anyway,
nice.
You were on Broadway, and
I was
what happened?
On Broadway. But the point is that you always look into the audience and see the person who's like, and I mean, you know, people come to rest in
yes,
the Broadway.
Yeah.
They're no kidding. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. They and it's very loud in the house, but they do come and just sleep and sleep, and
their
so you can always see those people and their cell phones go off and all kinds
yeah.
of stuff. Yeah.
They fart. And we've
you
come
love,
full circle.
Oh, that's beautiful. It's poetic. And
yeah. we've finished now. It's the end of the time you have to talk.
It is?
Yeah. It's always an issue with me how to get to the commercial without looking cheesy.
Well, you could just really depress your guest like you just did.
Tonight, on a very special Late Late Show, the part of Nadine, the sexy English cat, will be played by Lauren Graham.
Hey!
What I do, everybody? I'm very excited. I got a girlfriend. Why don't you come on out, honey? Say hi. Come on. Hey. Isn't she cute? Tell him your name, honey. Come on.
My name's Nadine.
Nadine? That's yes. A beautiful name, isn't it, ladies and gentlemen? Nadine, yeah. So, Nadine, where are you from, honey? I mean, I know this, but I'm just asking you so that the folks on TV, hey, everybody, so that they know where you're from. So tell them where you're from, honey.
I'm from London, England, in the Europe.
Really? Don't you think, Nadine, you could have chosen an easier accent? I now find myself, Nadine, speaking in an English accent. Very difficult for me to speak to you without...
You're not one to talk with that horrible southern accent. It's not...
Don't cross me, baby. I love you, honey, and you're cute, but I will eat you.
Yes, well, I will make shoes out of you and a bag.
Baby, I love it when you talk dirty.
Then I will make a belt.
Ooh. Will you wrap it around that little firm waist of yours, baby?
Yes.
Hey, everybody. Yeah. Hey, Nadine.
Yes?
Do you enjoy the work of Josh Groban?
Oh, yes, he's got lovely hair.
Are we talking about the same dude here? I'm talking about Josh Groban, you know, the prayer, that guy, you know, the singer guy.
Oh, yes, he sounds lovely.
yeah. I loves me some English girl. I always enjoyed doing the English girls what they did to Scotland.
What's that?
Know what I'm saying?
No, I'm just from England.
All right. What are you doing in L.A., honey? Are you, you're looking for work? Yeah, trying to be an actress or, you know, a cat?
Yes, I'm trying to be a bicycle messenger.
You really didn't think that one through, did you? Yeah, come on. You're an English bicycle messenger cat in L.A.? What the hell is wrong with you?
In this economy, you have to have an imagination.
No, you're sounding an awful lot like a goat to me. Yeah, but hey, don't be mean on yourself now. You know what Daddy likes. I like a little junk in the trunk. Yeah. I like a little juice in the caboose. You know what I'm saying, man? Yeah, that's right. You know what Daddy likes. Hey, come on, let's get out of here. I want to take you a little place I know that the cops don't know about.
All right.
It's called NBC.
What did we learn on the show today?
Hey, everybody. Hi.
Hello. Hello.
You really make me laugh with that English accent, baby. So funny. Sometimes it sounds English, sometimes it sounds Pakistani.
I will make you into luggage.
Yeah, we've been there, baby. Now, listen. So, what did you think of the show tonight? You enjoy the kind of desperate middle-aged white guy, Ferguson? Do you like him?
I love him very much.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Is he from the same part of the world as you? Because the accent seems so very different. Maybe.
No, he's from someplace different.
Yeah.
What
part of England are you from, baby?
I told you I'm from London.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
You never listen, I'm going to break up with you.
Oh, no, no, baby, 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 come on, sweet baby. Baby, no, I'm begging you, baby. Look, come on, baby. Please, honey, please. Don't leave me.
All right, I won't. I love you, alligator.
Oh, I love you too, pussy.
What to do? No, no, don't. I know many evenings I come out here with a sort of devil may care joie de vivre. Yeah, I speak French. Get over it, bitch. So, you know, but what you've been seeing is a facade. These are the tears of a clown, crocodile tears, if you will, because I'm really hurting inside. I don't know if you know that some time ago I told you that I had a girl that I loved. Her name was Nadine, and she was from England, but and then I told you I ate her.
It's good to see you, baby. You're still a little high, right? So now, I told the folks at home, baby, that I ate you.
Yes. Yes, lovely, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, but ain't she cute, everybody? So, here's the thing. I told them that because I was embarrassed to tell them the truth, baby.
Please tell them.
Oh, all right then. I was kind of hoping you'd tell them, baby. But...
All right.
Well, yeah.
The truth is,
yeah.
You didn't eat me at all.
That's true. That is true. I did not.
You only chewed on me a little bit.
Hey, what can I say? I'm part European. Now, listen. The thing was that Nadine left me and went to Europe, and I was embarrassed to tell you because I wanted you to think I was cool and that no girl could ever break my heart, but Nadine broke my heart, and I didn't want to say that. And now that she's come back to me, everything's cool.
Well...
Isn't that right, baby?
Yes, it's lovely, very nice.
Yeah. Are you sure you're from England, baby? You just sound like one of them infomercial dudes to me. Huh?
No, I don't care about Hoovers and their suction, so no.
All right, well, say hi to the folks. I just wanted to let you know. We'll be right back with Nadine. Give me a kiss, baby.
Hello.
What lovely hair and shoes you have.
That's not what you said at the break.
And your breasts are attractive too.
Thanks.
You do look nice, and you're playing somebody's mom in this show.
Yeah.
A teenager's mom? That doesn't make any sense.
Two teenagers' moms.
Really?
Yeah. It's true.
It doesn't make any sense. So you're still at the acting then?
Yes, because you won't let me come and be your co-host.
I would love you to be my co-host.
No, you want a skeleton on a bicycle or whatever.
Look. Here, where is it? Hold on. Here, hold that a minute.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, here's one left over from the old late night wars. Hold that a minute as well. All right. No, you better not.
Oh, no.
You're working for them now. All right.
Oh, yeah, that's my boss.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
All right,
and
so.
Liza. All right. Yeah.
So, look, this is the kind of thing I'm after. This is not really you.
I just don't understand it. What kind of breasts does this thing have?
Well, none yet.
Ew!
Oh,
also, I'm not. No, it's going to be a dude. It's going to be a robot skeleton. Well, I don't know. It's this robot skeleton. They're asexual. Although I have chosen a name for him.
What is his name?
You ready?
Yeah.
No, I haven't told anybody this. I've chosen a name for my robot skeleton sidekick.
Okay.
Jeff Peterson.
I think I dated him.
Are you on the Twitter?
No, but somebody, I think maybe several people pretending to be me are on the Twitter. So how am I doing? I don't know.
I used to get a bit of that. That's why I went on.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
But now you're obsessed with it and you're kind of gone crazy.
No, have I? I don't think so.
No. Only a little more than usual.
I'm just trying to have a good time.
Oh, I know.
I just want robot skeletons and stuff.
Tell me of the fun you're having on the Twitter. Are you having a good time?
It's all right. Some people are really jerks, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you must do emails.
No,
or
nothing? I don't do anything. I don't do the Facebook or anything. I'm too sensitive. I can't take it.
What about writing? Do you ever do writing?
Oh, no, that's for old people. No, I do that.
What about reading? You ever read anything?
This thing, you know?
Oh,
this
yeah.
This is how I do
yeah,
all yeah. my... So, you know, it gets
the job done. Stonemasonry. Have you ever tried stonemasonry?
No, have you? Have you ever shod a horse, though? I have.
Oh.
Not shot one.
Well, you just said shot one, and then...
Shod one. Like a, you know?
You put a shoe on a horse.
Yeah, yeah.
One of your fabulous shoes, or just a regular horse shoe?
Only after you complimented him on his breasts. Then you give him new shoes.
Don't compliment a horse on his breasts.
No.
I learned that the hard way. Yeah.
No, I was a horse person growing up, and I have shod a horse.
That's actually quite hard, shodding a horse, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Shoeing a horse.
Shotting. Let's just go with shotting.
No, I think
anyway,
shooing. Yeah.
Anyway, but how is the Twitter going?
No, I want to talk about the horses. Do you still ride around on horses? Like, do you go to work on a horse?
Yeah, it goes with the stonemasonry communication. I pull up to the gate. I can't even do it. How would you pull up to the gate at work on your horse? Yeah. And there's my ID.
That's all right, I remember you from yesterday. That's probably what you'd say.
That's good.
Do you actually have a horse then? Do you ride around? No,
I did as a kid. I worked in a barn and I, you know, rode every day.
Wow.
It's what I thought I was going to do with my life.
And then what happened?
I don't know. Show business. No, I don't
know. Was there a traveling circus that came through town with maybe a handsome acrobat?
No, I got, you know, in the school play. So I stopped riding. And, I was going to be a mounted police person or a jockey, but wasn't going to work out. And I just had those were my choices because I can't type. It was
stonemason, horse person, jockey, mounted police person, or actress.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank God this kind of is working out.
No, it's working out well.
And, yeah.
And it's Ron Howard and
Brian Grazer.
That's the one.
The guy with the hair. Hey,
a bit like that actually his hair, isn't it?
Yeah. Great, now I've insulted two of my bosses.
Yeah, that's right. We'll get to Howard before the commercial break.
Ron Howard's like the nicest person. It's crazy. I get so nervous because he's so nice and I'm so sarcastic. I'm afraid I'm going to deeply offend him with my, like, you know, hey, blah, you know, like whatever I do.
Your double pistol dance? You're gonna scare one of the most powerful men in Hollywood with your double pistol dance? Yeah, I can imagine.
And so I get like real quiet around him because I don't know how to be if I can't be sarcastic. I don't know what to say.
Was that sarcastic there when you said that there?
No.
All right.
Yeah, so he's so nice. He's so nice and it makes me nervous. But do you know?
Of course he's nice.
Yeah, yeah. Well, why? I mean, no, it could just be an act.
Well, it might be an act for you. Maybe he is not nice.
Why would he put it on just for me?
Well, because he's frightened of the two pistons.
It also has a sound to it. It goes...
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Well, that's good.
It's scary.
Yep. I was a bit scared there.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. But do you know, I have always wanted to be blonde too.
Well, let's do it for a night.
Can we though?
I don't know. I mean, apparently, if there's enough people on Twitter.
But can they Twitter on my for you know on my behalf to you since I'm not on the Twitter?
I can't be answering your Twitters. I've got no Twitter to answer.
Why not? Show to do it. You can do it all day, and then on the show you can answer some of my Twitters just about if I'm gonna be blonde or not. Come on.
All right, but only because I'm frightened of that. Yeah. We're completely out of time, which kind of bothers me a bit.
I know. Well, yeah. I just haven't seen you nearly enough.
All right. But do you what?
Should we? What? I mean, what are the options? You're in charge.
Well, you
it know. Says zero on the clock. It seems very yeah. honest.
I know, and he's kind of moving backwards and forwards a bit as well.
Uh-oh. What does that mean? What do you mean? What do you
mean? Well,
moves?
I mean, well, he's uncomfortable.
He's, like, nervous.
Well, he thinks I'm going to bump the second guest.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, no.
Yeah.
Do you know that I just have to tell you that I was bumped this morning. I've been doing press this morning
yeah.
for a veterinarian in Alabama who was tending to a puppy. But the puppy had pneumonia.
That's not a laughing matter.
No, I know. Well, that's why. I couldn't be upset, but it was a live kind of, you know, satellite thing, and they kept saying, you know, hold on. And then the vet was taking calls about the puppy with pneumonia. And then they were like, we're out of time for you and your parenthood show.
Well, actually, my next guest.
Puppy with pneumonia,
yeah. We'll check to the emails and the tweets and the ding dong. Is that the doorbell? It's Lauren Graham. Hi, come on up. Oh, hi. Oh, Lauren, how lovely to see you. Gosh, you look fabulous.
Thanks.
You look great. You look. Didn't you wear that last time you were on the show?
No.
All right. Lovely hair, lovely shoes.
Don't talk about my boobs.
Okay. Hey, did that? You just rang the doorbell and then ran in. You didn't even wait for me to answer the doorbell.
I didn't understand the setup.
Ding dong! And then you just ran in. It's like,
maybe I'm very familiar with this house and I just let myself in the door. Or not. Thank you.
All right, will you help me with the emails then?
Yeah.
All right, because there's a lot of needy people out there that need advice.
All right.
All right, this is from Michelle in Brentwood, Tennessee.
All right.
All right, she says, hey, Craig, I'm a 19-year-old college student and never had a boyfriend. Do you have any advice to attract men? Well, this is more one for you, really, isn't it?
Oh, well,
tell her to go like that.
Like this?
Yeah. Oh. No,
no, I don't want to do that. Help her out.
All right.
Oh, you don't care about her. All
I do,
right,
of course
fine.
I do. Michelle. Yeah.
Michelle.
Yeah.
Well, you should study hard and
men love a good study.
Eventually they do.
Eventually they do, actually, that's true. But oftentimes in college at age 19, sometimes I'm not.
Well,
I'm
what's your advice? Like pad the bra and bleach it blonde and let's go? Yeah.
No, 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 not at no. all. No, no, no,
no.
My advice to Michelle is be happy with yourself and be patient.
I don't think that's really good. Yeah.
I'm all right. We'll get that later. All right, here's another one. This is another email, all right?
All right.
This is from Cheryl in Ferdinanda Beach in Florida.
Fernandina,
that's what I meant. Have you ever been to Ferdinanda Beach?
No, I have not. No, but there's that ABBA song, Fernandina Beach, Fernando, you know?
Do you hear the drums, Fernando?
Yeah, do you hear the drums, Fernandina Beach?
Don't sing it, though, because...
Then we have to pay for it?
Yeah, that's
yeah,
right.
Yeah. I know. I'm on the T and the V.
The T and the V?
Yeah.
What's that?
What we're doing right now, television. Yeah.
This isn't TV.
Oh,
this
right.
is no, this is just crap at night. No.
Sure, right.
It's not TV, it's crap at night. The Cheryl says, Dear Craig, have you ever been on a ghost tour? If so, where and when? I have. Have you been on a ghost tour?
I don't even understand what that is. Is it a tour of led by ghosts? Or is it a tour where you go and see ghosts, which is stupid because everybody knows you can't see ghosts unless they want you to? Or is it or is it a tour that used to exist, but everybody moved, and so it's a ghost tour? Which is it?
I didn't know. They didn't say which one it was. So. I'm afraid we can't. If you can't be specific, we can't help you.
Exactly.
All right. Here's a Twitter.
Okay.
This is from Joe in State College.
Is that what Joe looks like?
No. This is CBS's way of telling me it's a Twitter. They put a picture of a bird on it.
Like you wouldn't understand otherwise. Or
no.
Something?
They don't think highly of me here. Anyway, Joe in State College, he says, want to join my fraternity mates in Lauderdale for spring break?
I
can't go.
Why?
Well, I spring break, I'm usually, you know...
In Miami Beach?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But wait, maybe I could put them together with a 19-year-old college student who never had a boyfriend.
No.
Put them aside.
It's going to be a shocker. It's going to be a shocker for Michelle, though.
I don't know. Probably Joe in State College isn't quite the sophisticated, debonair man about town he thinks he is.
Yeah, I don't want to send her on spring break. Let's send her to ghost tour.
All right. All right. Sorry, Michelle. All right.
How do you know? How can you be so sure? You didn't even look at it.
Yeah,
oh, wow. They're all the tweets.
They're all the tweets.
The kids on the tweeting, not as good as the emailing kids.
Sometimes that happens. There's no real, system here.
Oh. Am I going to get in trouble with the tweet people or something? I'm afraid of them. They all look like birds.
Yeah, they are. That's how you can tell if someone's on the Twitter. If you see someone walking down the street, back, back, back.
Yeah. Scary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you see that film, The Birds?
Yes.
That's scary, that film.
It's really scary. Have you only just seen it?
Yeah. It came out in, 1961.
Yeah, they're attacking.
I missed it for some reason.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just saw it.
You know what else is scary? Jaws.
Jaws is terrifying. Hey, you know what I like in Jaws, though? See when they have that guy that says, we're going to need a bigger boat.
Yeah. That's Rod Steiger.
No,
no, Roddy
no,
McDowell.
That was Robert Ron. Shaw.
Roy Scheider.
Roy Scheider's the mayor.
Is the man.
But the guy that plays Quint is Robert Shaw. Robert Shaw.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
So.
I like it because do you know who was involved in that movie?
Who?
Many people.
Going to say something.
So did I, and then I got to the end of my sentence, and there was nothing there.
Steven Spielberg
was involved.
He was involved.
And that was when they said, we're going to have to close the beaches on the 4th of July, and everybody's like, you're crazy.
Yeah.
That's my favorite bit. All right.
What are we doing?
we're doing the last email now. This is from Taylor in Tampa in Florida.
Okay. Right. A lot of Florida today.
Yeah, but that's
a lot of Florida today on the morning show. That's what it feels like, doesn't it? Oh, Craig.
I know. Thanks, Lauren. Hey.
The weather is...
Do you wear adult diapers? Find out.
If you do, it's good. We should have a morning show.
I'd like to do a morning show.
Then you'd be up late and up early, though.
Oh, yeah, because this is live.
Yeah. It's really late right now.
Well, it's dark.
I know.
That wasn't a joke, by the way. I really did that.
But even when you do that, when you're not kidding, you're funny because you're so funny.
You be careful. All right. This is from Taylor in Tampa in Florida, who says, Hi, Craig. I'm a huge fan from Saudi Arabia. I thought she was going to say, I'm a huge fan of Saudi Arabia.
So
yeah, and I think, well, you got the wrong address. I'm a huge fan from Saudi Arabia. I was wondering if you had the chance to come to Saudi Arabia, would you... If I had the chance to go to Saudi Arabia, would I and why?
Well, because you were invited. That's one reason.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's a lot of people who just want you to come with them places, you know? Like on spring break and stuff.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah,
yeah.
And Saudi Arabians, they want me there.
Yeah.
They want me there for spring break.
Yeah, yeah.
But spring break in Saudi Arabia, not that exciting. Woohoo, we're not doing anything. Yeah, yeah. That's not that exciting.
Yeah.
You know. Take off your face thing. No. No, I think Saudi Arabia is not the big spring break destination this year.
Yeah. Well, where are you going to go? I mean, you should pick a fan and do what they say, you know?
I don't think I should, actually. No?
But then why else would you be on the Twitter and the email and the stuff if you're not going to ultimately be like, all right, I'll go?
Well, maybe one day I will then.
See?
Yeah, all right. Well, would you like to go somewhere with me for spring break?
Listen, we'll be back with adult diapers and,
Please welcome the lovely Lauren Graham, everybody. Lauren Graham. Hey, Lauren.
Hi. How are you?
That looks spectacular.
Thank you. I just had to show you. Because I just hobbled across in some last-minute shoes, because this is what I was supposed to wear. Uh-huh. But when you put your shoe on, it's not supposed to go like that.
Oh.
Just so you guys know, you know, it's a safety tip. And so I had to throw on some shoes that I can't walk in.
Can I keep this?
Yeah.
All right.
What will you do with it?
I put it on my desk, but what tiny little feet you have.
I don't have tiny little feet
yes,
at all.
Yes, you do. I'm amazed you can keep your balance.
I know. I'm such a dainty flower.
Yeah. I know. You better hang on to that, because I've only got one's not.
We'll
yeah, leave it
for
there.
The next guy.
We'll put it on the robot or something. Okay. That'll be fine. Or leave it turned up the other way. It's a great joke when we...
okay.
Yeah. You look sensational. You look
good.
Lovely.
You look good, too.
Oh, I feel terrible.
I'm getting a cold, too.
Are you really?
We have to stop making out.
I know, but if we both have a cold, it's probably because we had sex.
With each other?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Everyone in showbiz does this all that time, all the time, don't they? Oh, I am really
you
sick.
You can't even
yeah.
speak.
I can.
No, you no, can. You're doing a wonderful job. You're very good at your job.
What do you want? Are you good? Tell me about the movie. I never ask you about your movies. I want to hear about it.
Wait, this is the thing that I was going to talk
Whoa,
about before
look at
my
your
shoe
ring.
Look, I have solid gold knuckles.
Wow, Ooh. it's a ring and it's on two fingers.
I know, isn't that crazy? My fingers are attached to each other like in finger handcuffs.
Finger cuffs?
Yeah.
Is that some kind of weird sex thing?
I don't know. That is like all that's on your mind tonight. Or maybe all the time.
Yeah. Now you're getting warm.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, I think about sex quite a lot, probably. I don't
yeah?
know.
Like, how many times a day do you think?
Once. All day, though.
I think you are probably thinking about it most of the time.
Yeah. I nearly said a bad word, and then, yeah, and I thought, you know, I'm going to try and do the whole show without cussing. Then I can have a... Yeah. But, no, do you think about sex a lot?
I do, but it is more specific. I wouldn't say it's like, you know... Like, sometimes during the day, I'm like, oh, the shoes are pretty, or whatever, you know? And then I go back to thinking about it.
Well, that's very similar to me, although I think, oh, those shoes are pretty. I'm going to follow them and keep going and keep going.
Yeah. Hmm.
Or, those shoes are pretty. I could wear them whilst having sex.
Oh. Hmm. yeah. So, anyway. Oh, who's that?
It's money. Oh, that's a picture of my son there. I keep a picture of my son there.
I've just never seen it before. Oh, that's nice. I stepped on your nice sentiment by like babbling to remind you why you do this job. My fingers are in handcuffs. I can barely pay attention.
Yeah, look, I got. Do you want to play the mouth organ with me?
Okay.
All right then. Here, it's a sanitized one. Can you play?
Oh, that kind.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Well, I don't know. Let's see. Why does it have so much wrapping on it?
Well, to keep it safe from staphylococci.
Well, that obviously didn't work because you're really sick.
I'm a little bit sick. Oh, yours
which
is green.
Which side is it? Yeah, mine is really fun. I like mine. I'm going to take it with me.
Yeah,
I don't know which side it goes. Like this?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's right. Can you play it?
Yeah. Okay, ready?
No way. Go.
Yeah,
go.
Okay. What?
You can't play, can
you?
You can't play.
No, I can't.
You can't play.
Go on. Go on. I'm accompanying you.
Oh,
There you are.
Thanks.
That's you.
I love it. Look, I have so many. Now I have a place
to put it.
Put
it in your shoe purse.
Yeah.
That's what everybody. If you start that trend, everyone in Hollywood will do it. The new shoe purse. Like Paris Hilton will be like, that's not my shoe purse with my cocaine in it.
All right, I'm gonna do it.
Yeah. Do you ever do that? Do you ever like go to Vegas with other people's cocaine?
No.
So what you're saying is you always take your own cocaine when you go to bed.
Exactly.
Yeah. You're not a big druggie, are you?
No.
No.
What if now was the time I chose to tell you that I was?
Then I'd have to bump the next guest.
I start crying. Yeah, it's like an intervention.
Oh, but that'd be scary.
Yeah. It wouldn't be that funny, though, for the late night, for the kids, you know, watching.
I don't know. Some of them are quite sadistic. They might be like, uh-huh.
Yeah.
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 Not many, though, I don't think.
No. You're one viewer, I think, is your good friend. Yeah. Is it a man or a woman who you're one viewer?
In my head, it's a lady.
Yeah. Yeah. What does she look like?
She's wearing boots.
Yeah. Maybe just one, though, because the other one broke.
Yeah, one boot. this is really twisted. All right. Do you ever think about who's watching you on TV?
Yes, I guess so. I mean, people come up, so I get to meet them and see them. But I'm still surprised, and when I do what I do, in my mind, it's sort of like, hold on, I'm getting there.
All right.
Ow, we must be free. No, my fingers.
All right.
Not over there. I don't believe that it actually airs. It's always shocking to me when it does. Like, as far as I'm concerned, when my day of work is over, I might as well be in the theater. I'm like, oh, that was a good performance or bad or whatever.
Right.
And then when people see it and then talk about it and then it's on the TV, I'm still surprised.
Well, you better get used to it.
I think it's better that I live in the weird world that I live in. Like, I don't read any entertainment stuff, so I'm just playing along with the Paris Hilton cocaine thing. I don't even know if that actually happened.
Oh,
no.
No, it actually happened.
I mean, it didn't seem that surprising, so,
Right.
But I didn't read it.
I think fair. What if you have to spread your fingers quickly?
I can't.
In like, your pants.
This is my first time with Jeff.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. When you were here last time, that was when we announced Jeff's name.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Wow, look how far you've come.
Miss Graham, I'm crackers for you.
Get it? Because Graham Cracker.
Yeah,
I get it.
That's great, Jeff.
It.
Yeah, really, really good. Yeah, let's be sarcastic with him. Yeah. We'll be like the mean kids at school to Jeff. That was great, Jeff.
Graham Cracker.
Snap.
What did he say?
He outwitted us again. Yeah.
This is the job I want. Why can't I be Jeff?
You can. Jeff, you're fired.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know if you can do that hand movement, though.
What's he doing?
Knock it off.
No,
the thing is, this is true, right? The censors let him do the hand movement because if I do it, it looks like a masturbatory gesture.
Yeah.
But if he does it, he's allowed to do it because he clearly doesn't have any genitals.
That is sick.
That's absolutely true.
Are you kidding?
Absolutely true. They have lawyers coming in, sort out, like, well, he's a skeleton, so he doesn't have a business, so it's all right.
He doesn't have a
business. And, like, skeletons are like, hey, we can do that too. And they're like, no, you can't.
Ding dong.
Yeah.
But he's become like their spokesperson. Think how happy they are. They've needed one for so long.
There'll be a parade of skeletons. We're here, we're bony.
Get used to it.
Get used to it.
Yeah. What else could he do that we couldn't do? Look, we don't have to think about it now. But next time I come, I'd like a list.
Oh, right, great, yeah. I'll get working on it. Well, next time you come, maybe you can get some mouth organ lessons as well. You can do it on your own.
I'm very good. I'm very talented.
Are you really?
No.
How's the parenthood thing going now?
Oh, it's good. It's fun.
Yeah?
Yeah. I feel sad when we actually talk about work because I feel like we've run out of...
Well, that's usually when I'm winding things up.
Oh.
Yeah.
in your pants.
I don't know. Well, are you taking anything for your cold?
No, I don't take anything for anything. I just complain and whine and...
Oh, I do that.
I know.
Do men complain more than women when they're sick?
Yes.
Oh, see, I knew you were going to say that.
Are you kidding?
Yeah.
Yes.
Maybe that is women complain all the time so you don't notice when they're sick. How about that?
What if I punched you with my brass gold knuckles?
You can if you want. You can if you want.
I'm very sorry you're sick. I think you're going to be better very soon.
I think I'm all right. I think I'm on the mend. How about you? Do you think you're going to get worse?
No, I think I've sort of, like, licked it before it ever happened.
In your pants.
I'm sad that we had to encourage him, though.
Well, I was giving him an opportunity. I felt bad because I was sort of came down hard on him. Mm-hmm. And so
in your pants.
And so I was just giving him a freebie.
In your pants.
You're pretty good with him. You two Thanks. Should maybe take that in the road.
I hear that, girlfriend.
Oh my god.
You should get one of those. They're awesome.
I think that you should let me do Jeff the Robot's job just one night and see, and we'll tweet on the Twitter of the poll and have a poll of who's gonna win. It's gonna be Jeff, but I want to do it anyway.
Well, I think we should do it. Jeff has to do a red carpet event soon.
Are you kidding?
He does red carpet events
now. Oh yeah.
We sent him. It's in my continuing attempt to deconstruct this enormous mess that we call show business by sending robots that are, you know, pre-recorded to red carpet events to show you how it's all a pile of tootsie fruits.
But no one's caught on yet. Everyone's like, can we get Jeff for 5 minutes over on ET or whatever? Yeah.
Yeah.
Well.
Well, we're done.
Are we?
Not forever, though.
Okay, for till when?
Till when you want to come back. You can be here any night you want.
All right, thanks.
Yeah, you know you can. You know you can.
Yeah, I know.
I know. I know you do. Lauren Graham, everybody. We were... Please welcome the adorable Lauren Graham, everybody. Lauren Graham. To tell you, I've known you for a number of years now, and you've always looked good. But tonight, for some reason, you look better than ever. Your dress is stripy.
Yeah.
And your hair has a certain poofiness about it.
Yeah. Your hair has a certain poofiness about it.
I know. It's kind of weirdly. Look, it'll come off if I do that.
I like it. I think it looks cute. I think you just think I look cute because my dress is short.
Shart?
As you people would say.
Shart?
Yeah, it's
You're wearing one of them little shart dresses.
No, oh, it's only a wee one, don't you know? It's just a shorty.
Just a wee shart dress. Like a wee short person coming up.
Yeah. I took a wee short person's dress, but I'm very tall, and I put it on, and then it was wee short.
I like it. You can see lots of your bit.
You can't see any of the bit.
You can't.
It's not even legal. You can't. You're not allowed to see any of that now. But now I have to move and sit like this just in case.
Well, I'm not gazing at parts of you. I am a little bit.
Yeah, you are. Yeah.
I'm totally checking you out.
Thanks. Yeah. Well, I mean, that's, you know, why you do it. You know?
Really? I thought women said that they dress for other women.
Oh no, No, I dress for myself so that I feel good in my inner self.
I thought that was yoga.
Yeah, that's yoga. You're
do
right.
Do you do yoga?
No, I don't like yoga. It makes me angry.
Really?
Which I think is the opposite of intended effect. Yeah. I know.
What part?
I don't know. The whole thing, it's so slow, and you have to, like, do partner things with other people, and they're all sweaty, and you have to pretend like you like them. I don't like it.
Whoa.
You know what I mean?
That ain't any yoga I've heard of.
That's just Tuesday. I don't like... It's not really for me. I run. I'm like a runner.
Really?
Yeah.
Running your wee short dress?
Yes. I don't know what accent I'm doing, but I'm gonna keep doing it. I run in my wee short shorts.
Do you wear shorty shorts, like 70s shorty shorts?
Yeah, yeah, they're the most comfortable to run in.
Is there any place I could come to see you running?
My treadmill in my house. Gets
that
weird.
That would be a little weird.
What? Would you like to come and run in the treadmill in my basement?
Okay. Why is it in the basement?
Because apparently I'm a serial killer.
Oh.
Did you watch the movie Silence of the Lambs and over again?
I've seen it over and over again.
Me too.
Why? Why do we do that? It's so upsetting.
It's always on cable.
That's
so I watch
true.
It. And then I just watch for the... Oh, man.
So upsetting.
Yeah.
That guy is such a good actor, but then you could never picture him as anybody else, right, than that guy.
Do you ever think that when you're acting? You think, I better not be too good here, or I won't work for a long time afterwards.
I'm always trying not to be too good,
you know? That's an interesting way to put it. This is what I do here, obviously. Yeah. Don't be good, and then they'll feel sorry for you and laugh anyway.
You're very good. You know that.
No, I feel sad.
You're good, Craig. You're really good at your job.
No.
Craig. No.
So, Taryn, what is this thing you're doing? This is a new thing with your tongue.
You've done what am I doing?
You've done it like four times.
What do you mean? What is it?
You've been doing this.
Oh my God! Like Cher?
Yeah.
Yes. This is a fear I have, that suddenly I'm going to reach an age, because I think this is part of getting old, is that suddenly you do things that you don't even know, that you become known for, but people aren't going to tell you, because they think it's like your thing. Like, you know, like for a while I started winking, and I would just be like, okay, and I was like, oh God, I'm winking. I'm the person who, like, winks and stuff. Like, I'm going to be dead in, like, a year.
Well, people call you Winky.
No, they don't. Yeah. No. But what would this be called?
I don't know, Sherry. I didn't know Cher did that. No, Cher doesn't do that.
Like, one time I fell down for absolutely no reason, I thought, no, not even.
Really?
Yeah, no, just for no reason. And I thought, oh God, this is the end. I'm now a person who just falls down. Like, you hear about, like, old people and they break their hips and stuff.
No,
like, that's me.
No, you're exaggerating.
No, how much space is there between this and falling down?
There's years between...
Are you sure?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
you've got nothing to worry about.
All
it's
right.
The winking you have to look out
for. I know. Because then people think you're trying to get them in your basement.
Well, I thought when you were doing the tongue thing, I was like, oh, hello. Yeah. Someone wants to run in my treadmill, if you know what I mean.
Oh, darn it. Thank you for telling me. I'm going to look out for it now.
What, that?
I'll have to just keep coming on the show to make sure I'm not developing quirky tics that signal the end of it all.
No. Do you know, once at traffic lights, though, I stopped and I realized I was doing this.
Why? What does that do for
I wasn't
you?
Even in a car. I was just at traffic lights. No, I was in a car and I found myself... Well, it's a geezer thing to do, isn't it?
Yeah, because it means you're, like, you're dry.
I'm thinking about the early bird special as well.
Oh, yeah.
Meat. Yeah.
Yeah, you just have to watch the hair as you become an older man. I mean, you know. The hair
from the
wrong
areas.
That's the thing that to me says, when you see that on a man, that says, I've given up. That says, I don't care anymore.
No, you know how a man's given up?
How?
Get him to go to a strip club. No. Here's how you know.
At that point, I've given up. Go on.
No. Because if a man goes to a strip club and they have a buffet, if he eats from that buffet, he no longer cares about food and sex. He just,
he's picked the one that's more important.
He doesn't care about any of them. He doesn't care.
This marks the first time that I've found out that there's a buffet at the strip club.
Only the swanky ones.
Oh.
You want some ham? Have you ever been to a strip club?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, a long time ago. The end.
No.
Well, yeah. Why don't you tell one of your strip club stories?
Don't have one.
You
I've
don't?
Never been to a strip club, so it's all about...
Don't
you give me that girl eyes thing.
So.
I don't think so.
No, a bunch of us went, I don't know why, and the girls thought that we girls, it was a bunch of girls, were also dancers, which I took as, like, a compliment.
Compliment? Yeah.
Yeah.
Compliment.
The end. Really, that's the end. No? And then I got all crazy and went up and stripped.
Yeah! Yeah. That's the end.
Yeah.
You know, it's a very simple storytelling technique. You need the big finish.
I know. I've learned so much from you.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm the Joseph Campbell of late night. Did you know that?
I didn't.
I give tips to all my guests. Start your story, then a bit in the middle,
and then
strip
it
at the end.
None of my stories end, which is why I think we get along so well, because we just keep going on. But I am a little locked in imagining myself as a stripper, because I'd be so bad at it.
I don't know. I mean, you're smoking hot. That's one of the things that's required.
That's nice, but I wouldn't...
Wait, you just blew right past that.
That's exactly the kind of stripper I'd be. I'd be like, you guys don't really want to, I don't know, you want to talk or something? I'd just be like, I wouldn't have the like, you know, whatever weird guts you have to be like, look at this, y'all. Yeah. Like, I can't do that.
That was good. No. Right there. Wasn't that good?
No.
No.
Thank you.
That was pretty good.
Thanks. All right. Well, maybe, you know, next time I'll really have a story.
I think you had a story this time.
Yeah.
That was pretty good. That story you told about, oh, you girls went stripping.
No, we went. I don't know why we. I don't know. You do crazy things, you know.
Yes, I do know that.
No, no.
Hey, very quickly, how's the owl show going?
Oh, the hoot?
Apparently.
The hoot. It's good. It's good.
Great.
Yeah.
Awkward pause, mouth organ, or touch my glittery ball?
Awkward pause.
Okay. Now, let me just say, before we start the awkward pause, that I have introduced a subtext to the awkward pauses. Mm. The awkward pause is, I'm trying to look at an area of your body.
You already did that. Should we pick another one?
I know. Did you see me checking you out?
No,
I was. I was like,
oh.
Yeah, because you were wearing your little shark dress.
That's
it's a shark. It's a wee shark dress. Yeah,
it's only wee. All right, anyway.
Oh, right, awkward pause.
No, I don't know.
Well, I haven't seen you for a while, so it's very difficult to do an awkward pause because I feel like chatting.
Oh, well, then should we do, you know, balls or something else? I mean, it's your show. I want you to be happy.
You're giving me nowhere to go with this stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Wait until I start my show.
I don't understand.
Just let me do it, and then everyone will be fine. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and other... good evening. Welcome to week two of Jeff being repaired, so we have to have a different personality for Jeff every night. Apparently tonight he's not Jeff. Or Jeff's a girl's name. Are you a lady Jeff tonight?
Yes, my name is Jeff.
I see, and your personality will be that of a sort of... is there such a thing as a male and female personality? Or is it just to do with business, you know, downstairs? Genitals is what I'm saying.
You sound like Harry Potter.
Really? I don't think I sound like Harry Potter at all. Oh, I'm starting to sound a little bit like Harry Potter. Wait a minute, and you look a bit like Ron. Yes, you do. Oh, shut up, Ron, come on. Just say it, Voldemort. There, I said it, aha.
Do you have hair extensions?
Yeah. Just not in my head.
You're cute. I like you.
Are you listening to what I'm saying, or is it just a set of pre-recorded phrases that are just getting fired at me by some person?
Do you have balls?
Not on me. At the moment.
Oh.
Did you just move that hand?
What?
Your nails are lovely.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Where'd you get them done?
At the place where you get balls.
Well, everybody, I think a second Peabody is only a couple of seconds. We'll be right back. You ever been to Hawaii there, strangely weird ginger lady Jeff?
I have a place there.
You do?
Yeah, and we drink and we have beers and beads.
You have beers and beads?
Yeah, and then we get naked.
Is it me or does this look more and more like a very weird children's program? You have beers and beads and then you get naked?
Yeah, because we go swimming.
That's nice. Which stroke do you prefer?
I like the one where everyone is naked.
I don't think that's really a stroke.
It's fun. You should come.
About a nickel for every time I'd heard that, young lady. Would you care to throw it to the commercial? Would you care to throw it to the commercial break?
Yes, this is the best product ever. It will make you so pretty.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big night where Ron Weasley girl Jeff is all the rage with the kids.
That's so pretty. I love it.
What we usually do is, like, I blow on the organ, then you blow on the organ, and we have a little competition of organ blowing.
Okay. Now I blow.
Yeah. Yeah, the trick with blowing is to use some breath.
Okay, but I didn't want to hurt you. Did you like that? It was pretty. I liked it.
Very nice. Very, very
nice.
Did
you like it?
Were you out in line for the Twilight movies? Did you go and have a look? Did you enjoy the Twilight? Did you like you know what I'm talking about.
I like those boys because they're cute and they're pale.
Yeah, you know what? I got a problem, though, is that they went to Rio, and they're vampires and they went to Rio. It's very sunny in Rio.
You just have to use sunblock, a lot of it, like you use it, because you're pale.
No, I'm only pale because I'm in shock.
I don't understand, but you're handsome.
Yeah, that'll do for me. What time is it?
Oh, it's time for tweets and emails. Yay!
Yay!
And your emails.
Ooh, ooh. And your emails. All right, this is from Dan in Smithtown, New York. He says, you ever been to Smithtown, New York? You got a little place there I like to go? Sorry.
I have a place there. It's pretty.
This is just Smithtown we're talking about, right?
It's nice. You should come.
Dear Craig and Jeff, I will be proposing to my girlfriend the day before Thanksgiving while visiting her family. We plan to make the announcement at dinner. Any advice? Yeah, what you should do is put the ring in the turkey's ass. And then when her father's carving up the turkey, he'll go, hey, what, why, what's this? And the turkey, and you go, surprise! What do you think? You think that would work?
I think it's romantic. I like it. It's pretty.
Wait a minute. Haven't you been here before? I think you have been here before. Weren't you selling a fragrance? You were sitting right there and selling a fragrance. I recognize that voice.
I don't know who that is. But you're pretty. I like you.
That's all that matters. This is from Rachel in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Ever been to Baton Rouge? You like the Cajun food? You like the hot, spicy, refried beans? My apologies to all Cajun chefs. Of course, there's no refried beans in Cajun food. They only fry them once. It's not like, that's the thing about refried beans. You fry them again. Why not just fry them once and get it done with?
Because everything is nice when you do it twice.
Yes, you're right, actually. All right, Rachel says, Dear Craig and Jeff, probably means you, my friend has asked me if she can borrow some money, and while I have it, I don't trust her enough to pay me back. Should I just be nice and give it to her? No. No, she's only your friend. What would you give your friend money for to help her out of a tricky situation, you bitch? What do you think? Am I being too harsh there, Lady Jeff?
You said bitch.
Did I? I didn't mean to. I meant to say jerk.
Oh, then I understand.
This is from Laura in Arvada, Colorado. Ever been to Colorado? Would you like to go skiing there?
Skiing makes me cold.
Wait, put on a warm jacket.
That's such a good idea. You're so smart.
I'm really growing to like you. You're the only one around here that gets me.
I understand you because I think we think alike.
Yeah, I think we do.
Thank you. You're pretty too.
You're right. I should come. This is from Laura, who says, Hi, Craig and Jeff. I've been fooling around with one of my roommates in a friends with benefits kind of agreement, but I've developed feelings for him. What should I do? Oh, follow him. Follow him back home to where he lives in Connecticut with his wife and children, and then find the pet rabbit. Get in there and boil that little bastard in the kitchen. Then you laugh. You see that movie?
I like bunnies because they're fuzzy.
Hi, Craig and Jeff. This is from Lisa in Raleigh, North Carolina. Ever been there? Got a little place like always? Yeah. Hi, Craig and Jeff. Is there any band or artist you're embarrassed to admit you really enjoy? No. Justin Bieber, maybe a little bit.
I love him. He's so cute.
He is pretty. I will admit that. He's pretty.
He's pretty.
Yeah. He's got a nice voice.
Yeah, but I like your hair better.
You like my hair better than Justin Bieber's hair?
Yeah, it looks fuzzy. I like things that are fuzzy.
No one's ever said they liked my hair more than Justin Bieber's hair. No one has ever said they liked anybody's hair more than Justin Bieber's hair. He's got the best hair ever. Combed forward, combed to the side, up, down, everything. It's fabulous.
I like you because you're pretty.
You're winning me over. All right, what was that? Something buzzed over there? Do you ever do that? You think your phone buzzed and then you realize you don't even have your phone on you? If that's never happened to you, you never took acid. But if you never took acid, you don't understand the show. All right, we'll be right back. See you. You didn't see anything. We are not the droids you're looking for. Do that.
No, never mind.
I know, but Jeff upstaged my hair tonight. My new red hair.
No, it doesn't. No.
Jeff's hair is the same color as mine.
No, yours is
because I like it because it's pretty. You're pretty. I like you.
I like you too, Jeff.
Oh, well, that's nice. Then I would hate if things got weird. No, your hair's lovely. It's very,
thank
very
you.
Nice.
You should call me on the phone.
Okay. Leave your number, I'll text you. Late at night. I don't know what this is about, this arm here. I don't know.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
So you did pretty good.
Oh, thank you.
No, you were good. I think you came on a bit strong early on, you know, to me. I think that was just show business, though, wasn't it? You were just kind of flirting professionally.
No, I'm in love with you.
Look, it would never work. I'm a man, you're an appliance. Well, it might actually work. No, I don't think so. I'm married.
I don't care.
Yeah, it's not really all about you, though. I have people in my life that would care very much if they caught me cavorting with an electrical piece. Actually, I wouldn't really mind that much. This might work.
Thank you. I think you're pretty, too.
Thank you. And thank you, patient viewers. Good night, everybody. The lovely Lauren Graham, everybody. Lauren Graham. Lauren Graham,
wow,
you look sensational.
Thanks,
I mean, really great.
We're not going to be asking
No, we're not doing that. I love your dress. Are those
thanks.
Pockets?
No, it's a peplum.
A peplum?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a condition? You're going to have to wear a peplum.
It's fashion.
I see. You wear a peplum as a fashion device?
I don't know. I just, I know that it's called a peplum.
Right.
And that it doesn't do anything. It just sits right there and is festive.
Well, I could do that. I'll sit right there and be festive. How have you been? I haven't seen you in ages.
I know, I can't believe it.
Yeah, what's going on?
I don't know, the same, you know, the same thing, really.
Really?
No.
No, I don't think so. A different thing. Look, we moved into a different studio.
I feel strange. I don't know. I'm not... Hi, Jeff. It feels...
Hey.
Hi. It feels... It's new. It feels new.
It's a little new, but we got the fire roaring in the grate to keep you cozy. Look, there you are.
So warm. Very
crackling.
Yeah,
it's warm. And and Jeff's still where he was, you know, kind of over there. And...
Yeah, remember when I was Jeff?
Yeah, I do. When Jeff's went on holiday for a week or something, or his
I
brain
don't know
went
where
on
Jeff goes, but...
It was something to do with his chips or something. And you did sexy lady Jeff.
Well, I was a Jeff who was a lady,
right.
But still Jeff, the robot. And do you remember what happened? It was very odd.
Was it sexy? What happened?
Always. Yeah. Well, Jeff, the robot, as played by me, Jeff the character, had a crush on you, Craig Ferguson.
There's nothing new about this. This is all regular Jeff stuff.
But I, as Jeff, the lady robot, asked you out several times, and you got, like, upset, like, as if it was a weird boundary crossing where I felt like maybe... We had, like... I felt
is your
weird.
Peplum going off or something? What's going on?
I went home, like, feeling strange because you got upset that Jeff the robot was asking you out.
Lauren,
I have to explain it to you.
No, Lauren, it's all right. I you could never upset me unless I had upset you first. That was the only thing that would upset me.
But I asked you out, and you said, Jeff, I'm married. And I was like, I'm a robot.
Love will find a way? Is that what you wanted me to say?
It just was so strange because you seemed upset at the prospect of, you know, cheating on your wife with Jeff the robot, which is impossible.
Not entirely.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Not entirely. I like your jewelry you're wearing. That looks nice.
Thanks.
You've
I know.
Come into a bit of money then.
Yeah.
What season is this show in?
4.
Oh, yeah. Bling it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They go home at the end of the night with the nice man.
What, a man follows you around, lends you jewelry to...
Yeah.
Is this a Broadway musical or something?
42nd Street.
Yeah, that's right. Have you ever done Broadway?
Yeah, I did Guys and Dolls on Broadway.
Of course you did, and you were awesome. You played the part of the girl.
Yeah.
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 I forget her name.
Was I real good?
Yeah,
I was real good.
What was her name again?
Adelaide.
Adelaide, yeah. And then, because there's the guy and then the other guy and then.
I can't even remember their names. Nathan Detroit.
Nathan Detroit, Sky Masterson. Yeah, and.
Brown, Sarah Brown.
Yeah, and then Ricky.
Lake.
Yeah, Ricky Lake.
She's great.
Ricky Lake that's one of the most amazing characters in that
that musical.
Yeah.
Because she wasn't even alive when that musical was written.
Oh, she says she wasn't.
Right. What if Ricky Lake was in Guys and Dolls?
They actually, like, Ricky Lake acting in it?
No, a character named
called Ricky Lake?
Lake.
That was a guy?
I don't know. You brought it up.
No, I
know,
don't
I
think.
Did, I did.
You
I know,
brought
I
it
know.
Up.
I did, I did.
Yeah, you're all right.
Yeah. Anyway, she wasn't in Guys and Dolls. Have you done Broadway? You just were on Broadway.
Jeff and I did Radio City the other night, but only one night.
It's only Radio City musical?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it was great. It was awesome. We sold it out.
All right, easy.
Yeah, it was really awesome. Why weren't you there? I sent you an invite.
You didn't send me an invite.
I was thinking about it.
The last thing that you sent me an invite to was your book party?
My book club, where all girls get together and we look at books?
Not that one.
All right.
Not strip poker. No. I mean, no.
50 Shades of Snap.
Ew, gross. No.
Really gross?
Kind of.
No.
I haven't read that book, have you?
Little bits of it.
You have?
Yeah. I looked up the internet the sexy passages.
I thought it's all sexy passages,
right? No, even the sexy passages are just
not sexy.
Yeah, that's just...
In related news, I wrote a book.
What?
Yeah.
Fantastic. I love the book that you wrote.
What's it called?
The Girl I Am.
No.
Do you change the title?
Yes, I changed the title. No, I wrote a book and I literally just finished it and had to turn it in today. And you wrote a book.
Yeah, but
I was
ages
at the party.
Yeah.
And so you know,
I've
it's the
two
most
books.
Bizarre. I feel it's a very strange thing to do.
Yeah, it's terribly upsetting.
Yeah.
My next guest has written like a 50 books.
I don't even want to be talking about it because he's the one who should be talking about, you know, writing.
I wish
I had talked to him before. I wrote a book.
Well, it might have put you off.
Do you think? I feel like it's probably very easy for him. I think he,
just writes a book? So
yeah.
What are you doing this afternoon?
Sure.
I'll write a book. Yeah.
I'm sure he'll really appreciate the fact that I just think it's, easy for him. It's like people who are, acting. Whatever. I could do that.
Well, to be fair.
I mean, it is
easy. Yeah. Listen, we're out of time. Do you want a piece of fruit?
Okay.
What do you fancy?
I don't...
I got a nice basket here. What do you think?
Are you going to do something dirty with it?
Yeah.
Wait, you have your fruit labeled because you don't know what they are? Teeny tiny pineapples.
I thought I was going to do something dirty.
What about this thing?
Do you want one of these?
Okay.
This is a coyote. It's at night, packs of these roam around in the desert. They're like, rawr, rawr, rawr. No, I've got a basket of fruit. It's kind of my new thing.
I want, another one. Can I have another one?
You can have anything you like, including the fruit.
All right. This doesn't look like a fruit to me. It looks like a tomato that's gone wrong.
Run off the rails, you mean? A tomato that's
crossed over to the dark side?
Yeah. It looks like an evil tomato.
Well, let's see if we can find another evil tomato. I think we can.
And now we will conquer the world.
The world is mine.
No, the world is mine, for I am taller.
Mine.
How dare you? I do find you desperately attractive. Kiss me.
Well, that worked out. Lauren Graham, everybody. Right. Guest tonight is a beautiful and talented actress and writer.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. And her first novel, which I've read. Someday, Maybe, that's the name of
that's
it. You
book.
Got it right.
Yes.
It will debut at number 15 on the New York Times bestseller list.
Wow.
How about that?
That's great.
Please welcome the absolutely enchanting and clever Lauren Graham, everybody. Sensational. Are your pants falling down?
Yeah. I picked them up, no problem. Got it. I'm gonna do your accent tonight.
You're mocking me. I haven't even complimented you on your outfit, and you're mocking.
Thank you.
You look fantastic,
thanks.
Especially.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was alive not that long ago.
Perhaps you can pretend it was sleeping.
Yes, it's sleeping. It's very, pet it. It's very soothing to pet it. Pet it!
I will pet.
Pet it.
I just want to know what I'm petting first.
I don't know. Just feel it. It feels good.
Okay. I will. But once I touch it, it's mine.
Look.
I'm doing that thing that Whoopi Goldberg used to do in Star Trek. You know that thing?
What?
Yeah, when
Whoopi Goldberg in Star Trek?
Yeah, she was
but
in Star Trek.
But you didn't pet it. Doesn't it feel nice? Yeah.
Yeah, it's great. It's like you brought your dog. Now, look, this is... Congratulations
Thank
on the
you.
Book. Which, two things. One, you know where it's going to be on the bestsellers list?
It just came out today.
Oh, well.
It just came out.
Congratulations.
Thank
That's
you.
Sensational.
Thank you. It's unbelievable.
That's great. And also, congratulations, because I've read it, and I haven't read it yet. I will read it. I promise you I will read it. I will.
What do you think it's about?
I think it's probably... I know what it's about, because I read a little bit of coverage.
What do you
on
think
it.
Your favorite part of it is going to be?
I think my favorite part will be the bit where you... is there a sexy bit in it?
Yeah, there's a sexy bit in it.
That's my favorite part.
Okay.
But it's about a young woman that goes to New York to be an actress and try her best. It seems like it may be partially autobiographical in some way.
It is in that I had that experience, but I definitely made up the details of what happens.
Did you make up the sexy bit, or was that a bit weird?
I made up the sexy bit. I don't do that. Ooh, gross.
In that case, I've read every word in your book. No, it's really, do you get concerned about reviews? Because people will review it and stuff. You know all of that's going to happen.
Well, mainly that's happened, and I have been very pleased to receive...
Good reviews?
Yeah, I've gotten
you
good reviews.
You bastard, really?
Sorry, yeah. Yeah, and one really nice one was from the Washington Post, which is my hometown paper, and it came out the day of my father's 70th birthday party, which was awesome because if it had gone the other way, it would have been a whole evening of like, oh, you know? And so that was really great. And,
well, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
And it's lovely. And oh, look at that picture of you. That's
yeah.
great.
I don't have any birdies on me there.
No, but you look very fresh.
Yeah.
You know, like you could get a bird if you wanted. Also, look, it's like this. It's like daytime, nighttime.
Yes,
daytime, nighttime.
Exactly.
various looks that Lauren can wear, daytime, nighttime. It's nice. I'm very happy for you.
Thank you so
much. You were a bit
much.
Nervous about it. I remember when you were writing it, you were like, oh, I'm writing a book.
It's incredibly vulnerable. You have no one else to blame if somebody doesn't like it. You can't be like, well, the director messed it up. No, I'm, you know, the person you blame.
Yeah, but the thing is, you can't really go through life worrying about what other people think of your work artistically. You just can't.
Well,
you drive yourself crazy.
You can't, and this was very empowering in that way because I wanted something that was mine and, you know, live or die. I mean, I didn't want it to kill me, literally, but...
Well, if you go riding around New York like that on a bicycle, young lady, you're gonna die.
Look at the nice Brooklyn Bridge, though. It's so empty,
yeah,
like it always is.
Yeah, that's right. The bridge is empty, and you're riding a unicycle across the bridge.
It's not me. It's the character.
That's not you?
No. It doesn't even look like me, no.
Do you know, I wrote a book once. Well, I wrote two books
once. I know.
Well, I wrote them both more than once, and then we decided on a draft. But the... But in the novel that I wrote, they put a picture of a man falling off. It was called Between the Bridge and the River, and a man's falling off a bridge, and it's a picture of his hand and his shoe. And I thought, people will think that's my hand. It's a little fat hand. People will think I've got little... And that was the thing that obsessed me for days.
Well, this getting this figure right was troubling because they kept submitting different girls, and I didn't want it to... I didn't want you to think it was me, but whatever. But... I definitely didn't want it to be the wrong-looking person. Even from the back, there are so many ways a person can look like not how I wanted it to look. You know, they had, like, flowing coats, or, like, in one submission, she was blonde, which, no
way. Hey!
Sorry, but she's just not.
Right.
And so, yeah, it was, I don't know.
Does she ride a bicycle in the book? I can't remember. It's a while since I read it.
Yeah. No, she doesn't ride a bicycle.
Do you ride
but
a bicycle?
It's the spirit. I do. I ride
really?
A bicycle, yes.
Around New York City?
Sometimes. I ride bicycles with my father as, like, a sport, as, like, a thing we do.
Really? Spandex and a helmet that goes
yes.
all pointy at the
oh,
back?
Yeah. We went to Ireland one year, we went to Vietnam one year, and this year we're going to Spain.
Competitive cycle racing?
It's not a competition. It's a group. It's like a, you know, it's a fun, structured trip that you go on. Do you want to come?
No.
Why? Why not?
Well, bicycles worry me because of the testicle issue. I mean, the little...
What do you mean?
Well, they got that little saddle right there going...
No, you can get... No, you can get it where it's cut out, so you have a nice little cup area for your testicles to go.
I'm getting older. I'm going to need more of a large mug. And then you've got to worry about the chain and the spokes and all that kind of stuff.
Well... You're worried about them for where? What do you
whirling
mean?
Me? What if my testicles get caught in some kind of whirling piece of equipment and fly me off into oblivion? It would be horrendous.
Did you have a bad testicle experience as a child? I'm just concerned why you're...
Well, put it this way. I'm a reformed alcoholic stand-up comedian, so yes. Yes, I did.
Well, now I'm concerned about your balls as well.
You mustn't be concerned. That's very codependent of you, if you don't mind me saying so.
What do you mean?
Well, you shouldn't be concerned about my balls. You don't
Why
even
not?
Have balls.
But your concerns are my concerns. I care for you, and I don't want your balls to be harmed in any way.
But I don't want the speculative nature of my ball danger to get in the way of your moment of triumph as your book marches up the New York Times bestseller list. So please, don't rob yourself of your moment of glory by, you know, meandering through
Craig's
thoughts
balls.
About my testicles. Yeah. Seems
All right.
sad. Are you writing another one?
I am. Yes, I am. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is it a sequel?
It is a companion piece, which is what...
What the hell does that mean?
Well, it's what they tell you. It's what they tell you to say so that people don't feel robbed if they haven't read the first one, you know? Like, you won't have had to read this to understand the next one.
So does that mean when you write the next one, you have to compress all of that one into the first paragraph?
No, I sort of... It does stand on its own. It is this same main character, but in another place.
Are there vampires in it?
If there were, I would make a lot more money. But no,
You'll make money with this.
Do you think?
Yeah, because somebody will make a movie out of this, too.
I don't know, but...
Yeah, they will.
They
Have you
will?
Sold the movie rights yet?
No.
I'll buy them.
Okay.
50 but, bucks. 50 okay. bucks right now.
Okay. Okay, good. Do you want to read it first or no? Fine. Okay.
This is Hollywood. No one reads books.
I know.
They're not going to be reading books before they buy it. It's like, what's it about? Mm-hmm, I like it. Let's go.
I think they're gonna just judge my book by its cover, which I find very pleasing, right? I mean, that's what you do, too.
I try not to.
Did you see the nice quotes I have on the back?
Yeah, who? You never asked me to do a quote for you. I've read books before. I could have read it and given you a quote.
Give me a quote right now.
This is the best book I've ever read, Mom. Warm and funny, charming and smart, Diane Keaton. That's good.
Huh? Diane Keaton, right?
Yeah.
You don't really have to read them out loud.
No, I'm going to. Graham deftly captures what it's like to be young, ambitious, and hopeful in New York City. Candace Bushnell.
You know her.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
She wrote the Sex and the
Sex
City.
Sex and the City.
And you like Sex and the City.
Right? You know I do.
I know. I've heard
about
it.
You've got some. Oh, there's a big, long
That's
one.
That's a long then. One. You don't yeah, yeah. that.
Totally Awesome, Justin Bieber. That's the one yeah. you want.
He loves my work. The Biebs.
Well, I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
Well, not that. I mean, proud of you. It sounds like I'm in some way connected with your glory, and I'm not. You know, you are, though. No, I'm not. I'm just, you know, I'm glad to witness your, you know, blossoming new career.
Thank you.
Second act, as it were.
Yeah.
I love that.
Did I retire from acting?
No. But you expand on it a little bit. Like, I always, whenever I meet smart actors, and I think of you as one of them, I'm always concerned for them, because acting doesn't require you to be smart at all. And so, it doesn't. So, I mean, I'm not saying it's not without, well, it requires talent, but it doesn't require you to be clever.
It doesn't require you to be book smart. You can just be sensitive and empathic, I think, is...
Yeah, empathic. Yeah. I think you have to be that. But you have to be emotionally open.
Yes.
But you don't have to be an intellectual of any great weight.
Yeah.
But whenever I meet intellectuals of some heft, like yourself, I'm concerned for them, because that's the kind of thing you get into trouble, because you're bored. You sit in your trailer all day and you go, I should probably get up to something. And then you do.
But... See Craig's balls. It's just easy. I'm sorry. It's so cheap, but it's easy. It's fun to say balls. And so...
Hey, did I look like I was upset or arguing with you?
No, no. I feel that. But I would say exactly what you said is what happened, which was I just needed something to do.
Yes.
Because I was kind of crawling out of my skin to have any downtime. And so this is what I did. But what I didn't know is if anybody would... care. You know?
Well, I care because I adore you, but more importantly, a lot of people care to read it because it's number 15 in the New York Times bestseller. So that's...
I'm so thankful. Thank you, people.
We'll be right back with Lauren Graham.
Yeah, because you read it.
Yeah. Welcome back, everybody. I'm here with Lauren Graham. I don't care for her, but we muscle through somehow. I'm joking. I love you so much.
Love you so much.
Love your pants.
Yeah. Well.
Those are the best pants on any author I've ever talked to on this show. Well, Salman Rushdie had a pretty nice pair of leather pants when he was here, didn't he?
Did he?
Yeah. Have you met Salman?
No.
He'd like you.
Because of the leather pants?
Yeah.
He just
He's like you because he likes you. He likes beautiful women, and also he likes smart, beautiful women. I think you'd be fine.
But he was with that beautiful Padma Lakshmi, right?
Yeah, he's not anymore, though.
Yeah, but she's really beautiful. I mean,
he's also crazier than a bag of snakes.
Is that right?
I don't know. I've never met the woman, but yes.
Why do you think that?
Because I like to think negative things about strangers.
Especially when they're really beautiful and successful.
Well, of course, that's
Why
the best
not?
Kind.
Knock them right down.
Yeah, that'll take you down a peg or two for thinking good things about yourself, which you probably don't anyway.
Yeah.
Sorry, Padma Lakshmi, I think I've been rather tough on you this evening.
I think she seems lovely.
What?
I was just trying to help you out.
Look, I think we shouldn't have talked about her at all. I was trying to talk about Salman Rushdie, and you went straight to Padma, his ex-wife.
Because, I can't... Let's not talk about them anymore. I feel bad.
All right.
Let's talk about somebody else.
What about... let's talk about... Oh, you know where I've been? Jay Leno's show. I was on
Jay Leno's just there.
Yeah, you were there yesterday, and I was there today.
Why didn't we go on the same day? It would have been so fun.
Well, then there would have been a tussle to see who goes on first.
Mm. Mm. Mm.
I would have gone second to you.
No.
Yes.
That's not true.
I would have.
No, you mean you would be willing to do it?
Absolutely.
That's not how they would bill it. You would be
yes, it
number
is
one guy. Would... No.
No, yes.
No. Wait, so how was it? Did you have fun?
Yes, I enjoy Jay's company. I think he's, you know, he's an enormous, you know... late night guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he's nice. I like
really
him.
Really hit enormous.
Well, he's a very... I don't mean overweight or anything. I mean, he's just like... He's got a very big face and giant fingers and... He's like... You know, he crushes things with his hands.
I don't think...
Gets real cars and goes...
I don't know that you'll ever be a guest on his show ever again.
What are you talking about? I adore Jay.
I adore Jay.
He can take a joke.
Yeah, he can. We talked about our love of denim.
Oh, he wears a lot of denim.
Yeah.
Yeah, he does do that. You do.
That's about how funny it was.
Well, he wears a lot. He's the person I know that wears a denim shirt and denim pants, denim shoes, denim socks, and a denim hat.
I know. But he does look very cute. But we were taught in fashion school, never actually went to fashion school, that that you don't wear a denim suit. That's a no-no. But iconic figures can break all the rules.
Yeah, I also think that Jayleno doesn't give a rat's ass about fashion
at all. Isn't it amazing? I would, if I had that much money, I would give a rat's ass about fashion.
I wouldn't give a rat's ass about anything if I had that much. Lauren Graham, everybody, we'll be right back. Tonight. I like
Thanks.
It.
Yeah. I like your tie, but it's messed up.
No, just pull it a little bit. Yeah, like that.
Yeah.
I like your dress. That zip just goes. Yeah. It's good.
Well,
it looks nice and warm, though.
What?
I'm trying to temper my creepiness with concern. Oh, it's very sexy, but it looks warm.
It's sexy and practical.
Exactly. Sexy for the winter.
You can control the temperature from here.
Wow, you are a little sassy tonight, aren't you?
I've got a zip-on dress, yes.
Yes, you have. Well, that's quite sexy, you know, a zip right down the front like that. It's like, you know, it's like a man's pants, but all the way down.
When I chose this dress, I thought, it's like a man's pants.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Did I just spit a bit there on you? Did
no,
you see
I didn't.
That? I thought I saw.
I'm not sure.
All right, I might have done a little spit, but don't okay. Please don't take it personally. It's just I'm reaching that age.
Oh.
Yeah, I've started just. Have you started spitting yet?
No, not so much. Do you have hair in like weird places?
Yes. And things start to itch, which have no business itching.
Like what?
Like the inside of my ear.
Oh.
Like
it's the hair. You know, that's what it's from.
There's no hair in there. I pour Nair into my ear. don't do that. It's very dangerous. Don't do that. You could end up hearing nothing.
Or everything.
Or everything.
Yeah.
Ooh. What have you been up to? Yeah, that show, The Parenthood's doing great. What are you on, season 7?
Yeah, let's say.
Is it?
No, season 5.
Season 5?
Yeah.
That's the big one. That's when you get all the renegotiation and money.
Not anymore.
Really?
No.
What's happened? They don't pay actors anymore? I'm sure that someone's telling you a lie.
It's just not, it's not what you might think, but it's a wonderful job, and I'm very happy to have it. Did I save that?
Yeah. I guess.
It's just not, that crazy syndication just
doesn't happen anymore.
Really anymore.
Yeah, that's...
Unless you're like Charlie Sheen or somebody.
Well, he's got quite a high nut to pay every month, I think, anyway.
High nut right there.
Yeah. I imagine he has to pay quite a lot of money. Do you spend a lot of money, too, or do you hoard it?
I think I'm somewhere in between.
Really?
Yeah.
What about items that you've had in magazines and cats? Do you hoard any of those things?
What?
Are you a hoarder is what I'm saying. Do you have, like, your house full of stuff and you have to make little passageways through them?
No, I... No, I believe in the cleanse. I think you've got to keep, you know, getting rid of things.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Do Are we talking things? Yes. Sometimes when I don't want to get rid of them, they just go.
Like what?
You know, in my tummy.
You mean...
You mean if cats are in my tummy, they come out?
Magazines and cats?
Yeah. No, I think I'm a little bit OCD. I hang on to things a little bit. I think I have mild OCD. Maybe mild to moderate. I don't know. It kind of varies.
Well, that's okay. You're a nice person.
Well, there's no morality attached to illness, surely, is there?
I'm surprised. I would think that you have a very clean, like, spare living environment.
No, I have two children. I have a very poo-covered living environment. And that's only for me. The kids are worse.
I feel like we've been talking about poo a lot. Do you?
Well, I'm European, so...
Well,
what can I tell you? What have you been up to? Did you take a vacation this year? I haven't seen you all year.
I feel like I just saw you.
All right, then. Did you take a vacation since I saw you last week?
I went to Spain.
Spain?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. Why didn't you mention that?
You just asked me. Oh. I went to Spain on a bike trip with my dad.
That's nice.
And we bicycled across Spain.
Which part?
Mm-hmm. The pretty part.
Yeah, well, it's all very beautiful. The northern part of Spain?
Like, sort of north of Barcelona.
Yeah, no, I've been up there. Yeah, Cadaqués is up there and Salvador Dalí's house.
Yes, we saw Salvador Dalí's house.
Oh, yeah.
And the Dalí Museum is
I've really been there.
Have you really?
Yeah, and he was still alive and living there at the time.
No. He's bananas.
Well, he's dead now, but he was bananas, yeah. Well, maybe he still is. No. Who's to say, you know?
Yeah, that's exactly what he would say.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
And there's that shrine or statue outside the museum to his therapist, right?
I thought it was his wife. Or it could have been just a giant lobster. You don't know. Did you go to the running of the bulls thing? Did you go to the Pamplona?
No. We were just healthy cyclists on our cycles.
Just cycling across?
Just cycling, eating lots of ham and cheese, as you do in Spain.
Ham and cheese?
Like all there is to eat there. It's not bad, but I mean, it's
you can
really
get
good.
Paella in Spain. It's pretty damn good, actually. I seem to recall. Of course, I was drunk, so... Maybe it was just ham and cheese.
Then you were in Spain a long time ago.
1990 was the last time. No, I went there after I got sober.
A little bit of cold?
A little bit. I've got a little bit of something in my throat.
Got a little touch in your
throat. Yeah, I've got a little touch, yeah.
Concerned about you with the hoarding and the cold and the poo.
I think I caught it from the horse. I was making out with a horse earlier on.
And that horse gets around. Yeah.
We got to take a break.
All right.
You know, I mean, just, I think we should see other people is what I'm saying.
I can't believe you tell me like this in front of all these people.
Well, it's just them. All right, we'll be right back with Lauren Graham. Welcome back, everybody. I'm here with Lauren Graham, you wrote a book, remember?
I do.
It's really good, I remember it. It's called the, remind me again, it's the girl who
Gilmore
loved the thing.
It's called Someday, Someday, Maybe.
Someday, Someday, Maybe.
And to my shock and surprise and joy, it was on the New York Times bestseller
list. Yeah, it did really well.
And partially, thank you. I'm sure thanks to you, because I was here that week.
You were here, and that's how books get become hugely successful.
Exactly.
People come on here, and I talk about them, and then that's what happens.
I know.
It's nothing to do with the quality of the book.
No. It's you.
So don't get ideas above yourself.
I would never.
Are you going to write another one?
I am writing another one, and I'm writing a pilot for a TV series based on the first book.
You are going to have so much money. You'll be able to rent a car and drive across Spain.
What? It's,
It's nice to see you.
It's nice to see you, too.
You've got lovely, cheeky eyes, I think.
How can you have cheeky eyes?
I don't know. Your cheeks go up like that, and then your eyes are happy and sparkly. It's nice.
Oh, my
Makes
God.
Me go, whoa.
Oh.
Well, we're out of time.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes. We have to see other people.
I thought things were going so well.
Yeah, that's just go, when I get you. No.
Can we try one more time?
No. All right, then. What do you want to do?
Go out to dinner? I don't know. Wait, what? I don't know what we're talking about.
No, I thought maybe...
Wait, do you remember? I had to join Twitter for the book. And I tweeted something to you directly of my love for you, and you didn't respond to me. I was so crushed. So now I'm breaking up with you. Ha! Gotcha!
Oh, no! Oh.
Yeah!
No! No!
I just remembered I'm mad at you, and now we can break up.
Whatever works. Lauren Graham, everybody! Actress and a best-selling writer and one of my favorites in the world.
And she smells lovely.
She smells great. I just smelled her hair.
Oh, what is it? What does it smell?
Oh, it smells like victory.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. She's just about to do the final season of Parenthood. She's probably done it.
Yeah.
It's ready to go.
It's all set.
And it starts this Thursday on NBC.
Yeah.
Lauren Graham, everybody. Your book is here.
Thank you. It's so nice to see it here in this on this desk.
Well, I read it every day, just a little chapter. And I always look at this photograph at the back of your book because it looks like you crouching.
Like I'm ready to pounce? Like I might hurt
yeah,
you?
Yeah, yeah. And it's like, buy this or I will cut you. You look great, sweetie.
Thank you, sweetie.
I like your jacket.
Thank you. It's a Yeats poem.
In glitter on a jacket?
Yeah. Isn't that great?
It kind of is, and it's horrible at the same time.
Yeah, because why read it when you can just wear it?
I kind of love this. Are there other literary giants available in glittery jacket form?
I don't know. Let's start a line, a clothing...
I'm sure it's been done. Fashion people must do that all the time.
I don't know what those people do.
Do you watch Project Runway? Do you still watch it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, me too. Do you like Zac Posen?
Yes.
Me too.
I love him.
I think I wasn't sure I was going to, because when Michael Kors went away, I was like, because I always liked what Michael Kors did. But then Zac Posen has got the, I liked what you were, but I kind of didn't.
Yes.
He kind of talks a little bit and then asks you a question at the end of what he's saying.
You're really an aficionado of the
Project Runway.
Runway, yeah.
I love it. I've got to get me some Tim and Heidi.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's thinking man's football.
I was a judge on Project Runway.
Yeah, I know. I remember seeing it.
Yeah. it was hard to be a judge. It's really challenging, and it's a long night, and it made me feel sad. I didn't like...
That's how I feel watching Project Runway.
I didn't like judging the nice people. They look so tired. They're working so hard.
Well, you don't. What you should do is base your judging only on who you like and who you don't like as contestants.
Just like life.
Yeah, just like life. Like, yeah. You know, it's fine.
Yeah, all right.
What have you got there?
Listen, I have two things. This was in the dressing room. This was my gift, along with a nice Craig mug, which I have like 10 of.
We gave you that?
Yeah. And the flavor, first of all, it's gravel. And the flavor is Salty Graham. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Salty Graham. Yeah.
Oh, her. Buy me book. Buy me book, why don't you?
Why am I so... Oh, because I'm a pirate.
Yeah, well, Salty. Yeah, Salty. Yeah, yeah. Ah, that's right. Her Parenthood about to go into its final season.
Final season? You're going to be done, and I'm going to be
done. You're going to be done. And, which leads me to this other thing I brought, and I just thought this was so sweet, because this is probably, I can't even bear to think about it, but I think this might be our last time on this show together.
Mm-hmm.
And you wrote me this nice note.
Oh, well.
Welcome back, Lauren.
I admit it is somewhat sparing in its prose, but James Joyce, who you are familiar with, of course,
I
think he's got his own jacket lying out, said sentimentality is unearned emotion, and I agree with him. Hmm. I don't think you need to be sentimental about this, for you and I will go on to greater things. I think we should do a show together.
Okay. What's it about?
We're detectives.
Okay.
Comedy detectives who live next door to each other and have a sort of chemistry, but never really, and you don't know if they're going on, and they might, and then they don't, and one night they get snowed in.
What is the name of our show?
The Craig Ferguson Show.
My agent will call you.
Okay. No, you don't think so? But don't you think that would be a good thing? We should do that.
I think there's a lack of comedy detectives out there.
There's hardly any.
No, I want some laughs with my crimes.
And maybe we could have... And the crimes should be, like, not big crimes.
Right.
But like, crimes that, like, who stole this hat?
Yeah. You know? Yeah. But then why do people come to us if they're, like, sort of meaningless crimes?
Because
like, are we good at our job?
Not particularly. But they come to us because we're reasonably priced.
Yes.
And we're very strict.
Oh.
With each other.
Oh.
And we've got a wacky robot skeleton lives next door.
Oh,
hey, yeah.
Takes such a long time to get a show on the air. Maybe we should try like the live show. We should like when we're done to go do like a bus and truck and just we like live on a bus and drive to city to city and you know.
Who gets the top bunk, if you know what I'm saying?
Who? You?
You don't want that.
Oh, my goodness. Maybe we should fly instead.
Okay. Separately in separate airplanes?
Maybe.
Okay. Coach?
Maybe we should do separate shows and just tell
each other. So what you're saying is I never want to see you again, but you're saying it in a nice way.
No, I'm very upset. I'm having more trouble saying... I know that we're not really saying goodbye, but I have had so much fun with you on this show that I'm truly... You're giving me the dead eyes. You're like, no emotion.
No, I'm not. I'm just thinking about that joke in the monologue earlier. No,
I'm having more trouble dealing with the end of our time than of my time on Parenthood.
Well,
not anything bad about.
No, I understand. I totally get it.
This has been such a special.
You're one of my favorites. One of my top 25. No. Can't you tell from the note? Look what I said. Welcome back.
I would like you. And it's not even signed Love Craig. It's just Craig.
Yeah, but there's a look. There's a little kiss there.
Not even an O. Just X.
Yeah. You know why it's just X? Because it's not a kiss. It's X.
Rated X?
Sure. All right.
No.
But seriously, I don't know what I'm going to do. What am I supposed to do? Well,
I'm serious. I think we should do a show together. Maybe a sitcom. Four camera sitcom so that we only have to be there a couple of days a week.
Okay. Are we detectives on that?
Nah. It sounds like we're just a married couple. And I married you to get my green card and we were just friends, but now we're falling in love.
By the way, this writes itself. Are you kidding?
Kind of, a little bit.
Oh my God.
Yeah. I came from another country. And we were just like friends.
Yeah.
And I said, oh no, they're gonna deport me. And you said, oh look, I'll marry you. And then, but they check up and said, well, you can just stay in the spare room, and then they get snowed in.
I really think it's a good idea.
And they learn to love each other and be married throughout the show. They have to. I mean, they got married just for legals.
Sure, I get,
but they, you know, then
what's
you know.
Called? What's this show called?
Marriage of Convenience.
Oh my God.
It's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's really.
And they've got a wacky skeleton that lives next door.
All right.
Actually, I'm actually beginning to get quite serious about this.
I know. It's a really good
idea. It's not a bad idea.
It's that movie, but we haven't seen it in a long time.
I've never seen. For legal reasons, I don't even know what movie you're talking about.
Okay. It's called Green Card.
Green Card.
Which would be another name of our show.
Well, we could call it Green Card. Yeah. But it wouldn't be for the Green Card.
No.
It would be for citizenship.
Yes.
Yeah. Or we could do it the other way around. We could set it in Scotland, and you marry me to stay in Scotland.
Do you have to do that there?
Yeah, you can stay if you like.
Yeah.
It's like, aye, come on in. There you are. Here's your potato. Have a great time.
I've never been to Scotland. I really want to go there.
That could be one of the episodes of our show.
Yes, yes.
Well, you come back and meet my family who are all gingers.
Oh. Then what happened to you? Why are you not?
I had my hair dyed at immigration. On Ellis Island, as I came through, they're like, no, you can't have ginger hair here.
This is an odd episode. I don't like it as much as our earlier ones.
Let's take a commercial break.
I feel like we've already jumped the shark.
No, let's take a commercial break, and we'll be right with you. We'll come right back with a complete treatment for the show. Okay. Hey, we weren't. If you are lawyers sitting in an office about 3 years from now, when our new show is a big hit and CBS are trying to get the money out of us, we're not having the idea you think we're having right now.
Anyway.
So that's it.
Okay. Well, let's do that then, I guess.
Okay.
All right.
And let's go on vacation because.
Okay, where should we go? Are we married in real life? I forget.
I think we've come close a couple of times, you know what I'm saying? A little weird.
What do you think it would be like if we... Oh, you're obviously married to somebody, so...
Well, yeah, but...
You shouldn't even conjecture, but what do you think it would be like?
If you and I were married?
Yeah.
Pretty fun, I guess. Yeah. That'd be good fun.
We're both tall.
Yeah, well, there you are. That would make for a hilarious show.
I'd think about that, though, because I have acted with some real shorties in my life. And it's, I know, no offense to shorties. I just mean, it's for me, I am always, like, looking down at people. And
they're like, I really love you. Yeah, I know. I know.
Yeah.
But, you know, everyone's tall now in show business.
In their own way? What?
I don't know. I'm just, you know, because, you know, you're going to upset somebody by saying either somebody might be fat or somebody might be short. People go crazy.
Right. All right. Well... Shorter than I am? Is that okay? My TV daughter, Mae Whitman, is in my dressing room right now, and she's a short person, and I love her.
Oh, no, you shouldn't have outed her.
Why?
It's got to be her decision to admit she's short.
Oh, she's got to come out with it herself.
Yeah, yeah. Is she here now?
Yeah. Should we say hi to her?
Yeah, yeah. Could you make it to the stage?
She's
going to
kill me.
Hey, just to measure.
Hey. Okay, yeah,
come
just
on,
come out
come
for
on
one
out.
Second.
All right.
Is she coming? Yeah, where are you? No, this is not okay.
You know what? You know what?
Hey! Hey! Lauren was saying mean things about you being a shark.
You know, I heard all about it.
Do you carry your own microphone?
I brought this with me.
You're like Chris Rock. You're like, yeah!
I was right off stage, like, waiting just for, like, a shout-out.
Yeah, not cool.
But
you're
so cute. I just came from work. I'm in shorts. I am short. What's happening?
I don't know. It's we're
Thank
saying
you for standing
to
down there. This helps. Makes it feel much better.
Look, we'll make it even.
Hey.
Hey. One big family. You guys have a daughter on the show, right?
She could be our daughter on the show.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, you deal with her. I've had it.
Anyway, I said, all right. Thank you, guys.
We'll be right back.
Bye.
Everybody, we'll be right back.